deep into Liberland. This is the border up here. We're not deep in here. We're just off of Liberty Island right here.
Because for us it's very important, the principle of non-discrimination. The freedom of movement is a very important principle in the internal market, movement of goods, of capital, of service, and of people.
Well, welcome. Welcome to Free Talk Live on this live Labor Day edition of the program. I don't know if we even have a network. Mark, welcome. You're here. It's Ian.
Yes, I am.
So I wanted to talk about Liberland to start things out here tonight, but I need to do a little technical troubleshooting here.
Well, I want to talk about the new arrests that apparently occurred on the 3rd of September. This is posted in the Liberland Settlement Association's Facebook page, and this isn't something that...
The Facebook group or the page?
I don't know, Ian. I really don't care the difference. It says groups here.
Okay, so it's a group.
Why it makes a difference to you?
It makes a difference because you can't get on the air and say it's on a page when it's not on a page, because then no one else can go and access it, right? So if it's
a group, it's closed.
It's a closed group. Right. So you have to get some sort of permission to get into that group. You're in the group, but I'm not. So I could not go and see this, and our listeners likely cannot go and see this. So
yeah. Well, it doesn't make you sound pedantic at all.
Okay. I'm just clarifying that no one who's listening can actually go and pull this up.
I was just going to say, you cannot get this information anywhere. There are 1,700 people on the planet that have access to this information. Right. I'm going to give it to you right now. There have been arrests in Liberland. The Croatian authorities have acted like complete jackasses, and I'm going to tell you about it right now. So this is Saturday last week. That's the 3rd of September. LSA settlers, the Liberland Settlement Association, went with journalists and guests to the Croatian checkpoint leading to Liberland. Equipped with valid passports and fishing licenses, the plan was to use the EU's right of free movement and non-discrimination to go fishing in Liberland for the afternoon. See, this way, not only could the people of Liberland go to Liberland, but at the same time, they could make the Croatians happy because, well, they're following all the requisite laws, even if this would be their land or whatever,
and
like the Croatians.
Upon hearing you come in and...
Are we back?
Sorry about that. No, we're not.
Okay. Sorry about that. So anyway, the idea is that you're following all the laws of the European Union, and so everything should be fine. Well, turns out the Croatian police first turned our group back around with the reason that one man had forgotten his fishing license. Fair enough. As the group returned, the police had left the checkpoint, and assuming all was fine, the LSA continued into Liberland. Inside Liberland, the group spent some time looking around, had a group shot taken at the ruined house, and then all of a sudden, police were everywhere. They forcefully seized everyone's camera, illegal, deleted material on the cameras, illegal, and forced them to leave Liberland with no reason whatsoever, illegal. Yet everyone complied in good order and left Liberland for the LSA base camp. Today, September the 3rd, an LSA member and a guest living at the base camp went for a day trip to Croatia. In the late afternoon, when returning to the base camp in Serbia, they found themselves arrested at the Batian border checkpoint. Charges? Well, illegal border crossing on Saturday in retaliation to participating in the above accurately described fishing trip. To add to it, as far as we are informed,
and
not even both persons did participate in that expedition at all. Demand from Croatian authorities, apparently a large ransom or 20 days of jail. Shame on Croatian authorities. Kafka himself wouldn't believe how you behave. Such a beautiful country and wonderful people, but what a pity it is run by what can only be described as crooks and bandits. And this is interesting. So they're using completely legal rules to go fishing. Can't you go fishing? It's the Danube River. What's the problem?
So they were allowed in. I was watching a video about this a moment ago, showing some of the footage when they were going into Liberland, which I presume they recovered after the goon squad forced them to delete it. Because if you know what you're doing with electronic devices, you
can. And these are the type of people that would.
Yeah, you can actually go in as soon as you're told to delete something by a cop or whatever. If the cop goes and deletes it themselves, just the trick is do not record anything else until you go through the undelete process. Because once you record something else on the card, it sure could overwrite what files were there. Basically, when you're deleting a file on an SD card or a hard drive, essentially the file system just marks the file as deleted. It doesn't actually wipe it from the drive or anything right like that. So
it's still there.
It just ticks a little checkbox saying, this file's deleted. And then it sits there and waits in a sort of deleted state, if you will, until it's actually overwritten by some other content. So they likely went and pulled this footage. And in the video, it shows that they got through. It was no problem getting onto the island, apparently, or onto Liberland. I don't know if it was an island at the time, but I guess it can flood.
Well,
it looks like they drove right on.
Liberland is both an island and a part that sticks off the mainland.
So, by the way, we are live now, so welcome to our radio listeners who were maybe worried that we weren't actually here live on a Labor Day. And thanks to our wonderful board operator, whose name I have not yet asked, at the Genesis Communications
Thanks to you,
Network.
Buddy.
No, I do appreciate our board ops being so dedicated as to come in on a holiday and transmit this show all around the United States to our wonderful radio affiliates. So you can join us here. We're discussing Liberland. If you're just tuning in, let's reset a little bit here because, Mark, we didn't even do this at the very beginning of the show and explain what Liberland is. We know that there are these activists who are having a difficult time actually physically getting to this plot of land. And Liberland is three square miles, I think?
It's about seven square kilometers. It's on the Danube River. It's what they call terra nullius. It is a legally unclaimed piece of land. Now, you know that Serbia and Croatia are relatively new countries. That came out of the sort of the fight there over Yugoslavia and all that sort of thing. And they, in this border dispute, the Danube River kind of moves like rivers do. So there's this little piece of land that for whatever reason is not claimed by either Serbia or Croatia. They both say, not ours. However, Croatia has been a real problem as far as letting somebody claim that piece of land and create a new country on it. If right. It's not a country, then you should be able to make a country, right?
They have been arresting people who have attempted to go to this Liberland place from Croatia, and I believe they might have arrested them if they've come from Serbia as well. I don't recall exactly all the different instances, but there have been, as of the last time we interviewed someone from Liberland, which was probably 3 or 4 weeks ago at this point, there were approximately 30 arrests.
Yeah, they're busy making illegal arrests over there. They don't care whether the Croatians don't care whether you come from Serbia or Croatia into this piece of land. And they are arresting people mainly for illegal border crossing. So if you're illegally border crossing from Serbia into a terra nullius, now known as Liberland, it is none of the Croatians' darn business, but they keep doing things about it. And this is, it's frankly bureaucratic overreach. They're throwing people in jails that are not particularly nice by European or American standards. These are unpleasant places. They're demanding ransoms to get people out, and they're just being real jerks about it. Look, if you claim the land, you know, if you want it so bad, if you want to prevent people from going there, claim it. But they won't do that because they know that the international community would be all over them for that because it's not theirs.
So just to bring our listeners on the radio up to speed, the latest situation in Liberland is that they seem to have, or they thought they had found, the Liberlanders, they thought they had found a way to get from Croatia into Liberland without harassment, and that was that they got some fishing permits. Is that right?
Well, yeah, they were going fishing, and they fish in Europe, too. So they have fishing permits and they have fishing licenses. They wanted to go fishing, and on the Danube River, just like any place else, you're allowed to go fishing where you want to go fishing. It's part of the EU's agreement with their member countries, and so what's the big deal?
So they got those licenses, and they were allowed to actually leave Croatia in order to go out into the Danube and go into Liberland to go fishing. but then the cops came after them later, right? And then they essentially demanded that they get the heck out, and they didn't make arrests.
That's true. They just sort of, you know, scooted everybody out of there. But then they arrested two people who had just gone to Croatia for the day. Hey, let's go to Croatia. They're in Serbia.
This was
very
close.
Couple
days later.
Yeah, a few days later. And then they arrested them coming back into from Croatia into Serbia, saying that they had made an illegal border crossing earlier.
Oh, no.
As we're referring to at the fishing trip. So it's just crazy. Now they've got people in jail. They're demanding ransoms and saying, or they'll say that they're holding them in jail for 20 days for legally fishing.
Didn't they also arrest somebody recently for saying something bad that they didn't like saying something, some sort of speech issue?
There was another guy that was arrested essentially in Croatia for, you know, like, I'm not clear what he said to the police, but let's say he cussed out the police. I'm not entirely sure what occurred, but essentially, you know, he's been arrested for saying bad things to the police. Young Danish settler. Arrested in Croatia minutes ago, apparently for using improper language in front of a Croatian official. Mm. According to rumors, his arrest was immediately followed by 8 more charges of the same offense. So maybe he cussed at them and then cussed 8 more times.
Those poor officials' ears, they had never heard such words.
Oh, yeah, you think? Let me tell you some of the things they've said regarding the Liberlanders that have been caught, you know, following their scanners and stuff. So, right here it says, oh, I'm sorry, I thought I had...
The Liberlanders have been translating the Croatian authorities, the things that they've been overheard saying. And some of them were pretty offensive. Some of them you're not going to actually be able to say on the radio.
No, I'm just going to have to use abbreviations like F and S.
Stand by. This is Free Talk Live.
Minutes, 1-800-717-9859.
That was my bad.
Pure Design creates only water vapor. There is no foul-smelling smoke and no nasty tar. This allows individuals to enjoy the nicotine they love whenever and wherever they are. The financial advantages over cigarettes are considerable as well. It is estimated that the average smoker can save hundreds of dollars a month with O2 Pure. Again, free starter kits are now available to any smoker who calls in the next 10 minutes. This is a radio-only offer not available in stores, so call now for your free kit. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859. 1-800-717-9859.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
As if chlorine in our water weren't bad enough, now they're adding ammonia?
It's true. Some municipalities are now adding ammonia plus chlorine to your water supply. It's a disinfectant called chloramine. But with a trusted Big Berkey water filter, you can keep chloramine out of your water. New NSF EPA certified lab tests show EPA Berkey water filters remove chloramines, pharmaceuticals, BPA, pesticides, bacteria and viruses, all forms of fluoride, and much more. Big Berkey water filters are the original and most trusted on the market. The gold standard in water purification. And our filters last for years at less than 2 cents per gallon. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get your Big Berkey today. Call 1-877-99-BERKEY or click BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. That's 1-877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
We've all heard the news stories. Another shooting. And they're getting worse. That's why Infidel Body Armor introduces Infidel Fridays. Exclusive 24-hour insider deals to save you money and possibly save your life. Make it a favorite when you log on to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Then be sure to visit each and every Infidel Friday to get special insider pricing, but for 24 hours only. That's InfidelBodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. It is the live Labor Day edition of the program. That's right, we're here, and we are going to take your calls. If you want to join us, you can bring up anything that you want to discuss. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, though we're discussing Liberland at the moment, and maybe you've been following along. Maybe you have been following a lot closer than we have, because honestly, we found ourselves curious before the show, like, what's been going on in Liberland? So we went and dug around and found the latest news for you, and apparently there have been another arrest, but this arrest happened in Croatia, or a couple of arrests happened in Croatia after the Liberlanders have been able to actually get into Liberland by getting fishing permits from the Croatian government. And then the Croatian goons came after them after they were successful at going in with the knowledge of the Croatian government guys. And then later the Croatian cops came in and took all of their equipment from them and deleted all their video material that they had on it, but ultimately did not arrest them at that time. But apparently arrests did come later for that. So the arrests continue of the activists attempting to get into this 3-square-mile plot of land between Serbia and Croatia. Our toll-free number to join us here is 855-450-FREE. And wherever you are in the world, if you can get delivery from Amazon, you can use saveatpurse.com to save 20%, maybe even more than that, on whatever it is you want to purchase. Anything with that Amazon Prime or free Super Saver shipping, whatever ships from Amazon, it's easy to get that huge discount that I'm talking about here. 20% at least is what I've been getting. I'll usually shoot for 25 and get that over at saveatpurse.com. There is a catch, and the catch is you have to spend Bitcoin in order to get this huge discount from saveatpurse.com. So this is a great reason to get Bitcoin. Now, you're going to have to spend a few percentage points to actually turn your cash into Bitcoin, but let's just say you spend 3% by going to expresscoin.com. Well, if you're saving 20% or 25% at Amazon, that is well worth the effort that you'll put into it. So go to saveatpurse.com. Watch the intro video there. It makes it real easy to understand. It's very simple. Saveatpurse.com. You sign up through that link and Free Talk Live will get a very small portion of your future purchases at saveatpurse.com.
So one of the things that you were saying was, is there was another arrest, Liberlander, apparently a young Danish settler went to Croatia and I guess cussed out some Croatian police over the Liberland situation. And I don't know that for certain, but he's been charged with, I believe, 8 counts of inappropriate language with an officer.
Right. Now, here in the United States, people will get arrested for that kind of thing, but those cases are usually thrown out or settled because it is legal to tell a police officer F you in the United States. But in Croatia, I imagine the rules could be a little bit different.
Yep, it looks that way. But things aren't different in the sense of hypocrisy. Mm-hmm. I'm of the opinion that any officer that uses foul language with somebody, you know, a citizen, and I don't care what the reason is,
unprofessional.
If you're arresting somebody, I suppose, and they throw an elbow and hit you in the nose, fine. That's something different. But mm-hmm. if you're talking to a citizen and you begin using foul language as an officer, I believe we should be talking about suspensions immediately. So here's some of the things that they've gotten off of the scanners from the Croatian police. He crapped. I'm trying to use nice. Yeah, trying to use nice language to
replacing their actual words.
And remember, this is being translated from Croatian into English, so it's a little can be a little choppy too. He crapped my boat with the mud. Frack his mother. That's nice. European swine. What do they consider themselves? I bet they don't do anything but this. They're just scumbags and drug addicts. Help! Help! They have two more boats. Even if I stay here, one of these two will F me up for sure. We have an agreement. Let him get out of the boat. We will take them down one by one.
I wonder what the agreement is.
I don't know what that means exactly.
Yeah.
He's handcuffed. Put him there. There are mosquitoes. We'll eat him. I don't give a care. Jesus, there's so many mosquitoes. Who is that? Is that the Liberland soldiers? It's ridiculous. What about that? Oh, I can't. J-off, effer, smart, butt, Nicola. You know the one with, we had him on the show. The one with the mustache.
Nicholas Nikolaisen.
Yeah, Nicholas Nikolaisen, yes. Was he with him this time? The list of all priceless right. quotes is endless, and it goes on and on.
I like that last one, too, because you can tell that they have a game, right, where it's, oh, we got to get that Nicholas Nikolaisen. Was he with them? Well, we'll give you 10 points if you got him. They actually do this. I remember there was one time when someone overheard the cops in Keene, New Hampshire, where we live, where you know there's a number of activists here, too, saying things that made it sound like there was some sort of contest on to see who could capture, with an arrest, which Free Staters. So it wouldn't surprise me.
It's like a bingo game. Yeah. They've got them all set up, and then they just tick them off. First one that gets them in a row.
Yeah, Nicholas Nikolaisen was one of the, I think he's like the head of the Liberland Settlement Association, which is where we're getting some of this news from.
Yeah.
So is that pretty much the update?
That's pretty much,
there,
yeah.
Mark? Because I've got, what actually sparked my interest in finding out what was going on with Liberland now, you know, it's been several weeks since we've had one of them on the show. It was actually, we had the gentleman who, I think his name was Crom, from Brazil, mm-hmm. if I'm not mistaken. And he was going to jail because he was one of the arrestees and he wasn't going to take the plea deal. And so I don't know if he's still in jail. I guess I'm curious to know what Crom's status is as well. There's a lot of threads going on in this little 3-square-mile plot of land. And Reason.tv recently did an interview with Vit Jedlicka. I'm not sure. I think that's close to pronouncing his
something
name,
like
right?
that.
He's the...
Jedlicka.
He is the president of Liberland. He's 31 years old. He's a Czech politician. And this is the intro piece, little 2.5-minute piece on Reason.tv. I thought it was worth sharing and maybe commenting because there was one kind of disappointing moment in this for me. And I definitely want to point that out here. But here we go.
But we would be larger than Iceland.
The Free Republic of Liberland is the world's newest sovereign state, lying on 7 square kilometers of unclaimed land nestled between Croatia and Serbia. Founded in April 2015 by liberty-centric politician Vit Jedlicka, Liberland's motto is to live and let live, and their goal is to find the minimum amount of taxes and regulation necessary to exist. They're welcoming to anyone with a respect for private ownership who is tolerant of other people and their beliefs, regardless of race, ethnicity, orientation, or religion.
Well, I tried for 5 years to show people that we might not have enough liberty in Czech Republic. It's same around the world. We've got taxes for regular working people as high as 60%. We've got 360,000 people from all around the world who are somehow registered on the website. If we accepted everybody, we would be larger than Iceland. We've got now people who are building Hong Kong, who are building Shanghai, who are building Dubai. We've got 600 architects on our list.
It's very interesting, the hundreds of thousands of people who within literally just a few weeks of Liberland getting some press, they kind of formed this concept earlier this year, maybe 6 months ago or something like that, 6 or 7 months ago is when the news really kind of hit internationally about this. And because of that viral news story, they received an unbelievable amount of applications. They don't have what it takes to process through 500,000, you know, 300,000 applicants. And I mean, that's an enormous undertaking just to try to figure out who you've got applying and, you know,
sure.
Who do you approve and all that. And they do have some specifics as to what will allow you to get approval versus not. We'll continue with the president of Liberland on Reason.tv. This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at patriotnecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
Patriotnecklace.com?
Patriotnecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from patriotnecklace.com.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting. ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue. I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines. Great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com. That's 844-2-GUNS-80, Guns80.com.
Attention, all men. Are you urinating more frequently? Do you wake up to urinate? Are you having a slower, weaker stream? Don't ignore the warning signs of your aging prostate. Get your free bottle of Super Beta Prostate. Super Beta Prostate is guaranteed to support a more complete emptying of your bladder, a fuller, stronger stream, and less waking at night to urinate.
Super Beta Prostate is a product that I really like. I endorse it. I use it myself. I was very pleasantly surprised that Super Beta Prostate helped me fairly quickly.
Super Beta Prostate is formulated with a natural plant enzyme called beta-sitosterol. It's so powerful, you'd have to take 100 Sol Palmetto pills to get the same sterols as just one Super Beta Prostate tablet. Don't ignore the warning signs of your aging prostate. Call now to get your free bottle of Super Beta Prostate. Call 1-800-853-1203. That's 1-800-853-1203. 800-853-1203.
This is Sharon Hunt. Before using Heart and Body Extract, my energy level was very, very low. I could only walk a few feet and then would have to sit down. I was tired and lethargic. But after taking Heart and Body Extract, my energy level has improved greatly, and I can now walk longer distances without getting tired so fast. Thank you, Heart and Body Extract.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie and let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the sacro wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the sacro wedgie.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! Hey, it's Free Talk Live, the live Labor Day edition of the show. You can dial in toll free and join us here at 855-450-FREE. Liberland, Reason.TV. has done a piece about 2.5 minutes, an interview with Vit Yidlaika, who is the president of Liberland. He's 31 years old, Czech politician, and a lot of the things he says and a lot of what I hear about Liberland, I really like. They seem to be liberty-oriented folks, and they really want to create a place, a very small place in the world, carve out their own free place, 3 square miles in between Croatia and Serbia. And I want to continue with his interview here in a moment, but we told you a moment ago how you can go to saveitpurse.com and save 20, 25%, maybe even more on the stuff that you buy from Amazon by paying with Bitcoin. But maybe you are saying to yourself that you don't have any Bitcoin, so you can't do anything about that. Well, the good news is it's super easy to get Bitcoin. All you have to do is go to expresscoin.com, where you can actually use code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency for no transfer fee whatsoever. And you can get more than $40 worth, and then it's only a 3% fee, which is a great deal. In fact, you can also get Litecoin and Dogecoin from expresscoin.com. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. And you can start off at expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, they can likely help you get cryptocurrency with money order or check. Go to expresscoin.com and don't forget coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live, to save on up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all. So expresscoin.com, coupon code FTL. As we go back to the Liberland brief piece here over at reason.tv, there's one part in this in particular that I was surprised about, and it gives me cause for some concern. Citizens.
Present-day America would not be mistaken for a limited government utopia, but Liberland's draft constitution is modeled on the United States.
For 200 years, you had a pretty decent level of freedom here, and I think we took the best out of that, and we transferred it to our constitution, but we were much stricter on government. You know, there is a direct ban on government to do, for example, any laws on public education, any laws on public healthcare system, any laws on marriage. So no more talk about this gay marriage or any other marriage, because government will have nothing to say in these areas.
Unsurprisingly, Liberland will not be part of the Eurozone, but they have proposed an interesting alternative.
We are not going to create a currency, we are going to create this merit system where we will be able to evaluate how much energy people brought to the project, and according to that they will be able to get the citizenship.
Despite Liberland's quest to keep government to a minimum, it does not intend to be a lawless state.
Yep. Okay, so before we get into this next segment, they do have certain requirements. If you want to become a Liberland citizen, you do have to bring something to the table, essentially. So it's not open to just anybody who fills out a piece of paper and sends a fee or something like
right.
that. You have to have some sort of skill or something that you're willing to bring to the table to help promote and create this society. And I think that's okay. I mean, you've got a very small plot of land here. It makes sense to... You know, make sure that somebody
it's
has
their
some,
country. They could decide what they do with it, right?
Right. Make sure that somebody has some principles or whatever before they show up there. But here's the disturbing part of this story.
We have to find that minimum amount of regulation that will make us acceptable for the international community. That means we do have to have these set of laws on anti-money laundering. We do have to have this set of laws on illegal drug trafficking. But we are trying to find the minimum, always the minimum amount of regulation necessary to get Liberland started.
Now, I think that that's good that they are, you know, trying to be as small of a government as possible. I think that that Liberland, if it is anything like what it is being envisioned when it actually kind of gets rolling, and by that I mean people aren't being arrested for simply trying to go there, is what's been happening. I'm sure it is going to be the least government of all the entire world and the least oppressive and all that. But it was disappointing that they feel they need to have anti-money laundering laws as well as anti-drug trafficking laws in order to be seen as legitimate in the rest of the world's eyes. That's just
well,
really,
I think
really
legitimate
sad.
Means that they're not going that. Yeah, I'm okay. So you know you. You have to trade something to get something in these mm-hmm. circumstances, and I understand where they're coming from. The question is it's not just what's illegal, but what's enforced.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, if they have an anti-money laundering law, but they don't ever arrest anybody for money laundering, then I guess that's okay, right? Or if they, you know, they have anti-drug trafficking laws, but yet people are able to easily move product in and out of the country, then I think that would be okay.
If you allow money laundering and drug trafficking, then what are you going to get for citizenry? And I don't know the answer to that. And that's something that you have to sort of figure out as you're...
Well, there's nothing wrong inherently with money laundering or drug trafficking. I mean, these are victimless crimes. Money laundering laws basically exist because of drug trafficking, because
many
things
towns,
are prohibited.
Many towns in the United States at one point were essentially run by the mob.
Yeah.
And, you know, that is a less desirable situation than being run by the current mobs, which is the cities and municipal governments, generally.
I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, I just don't want I want consistency in my government is one of the things that I really prefer. Obviously, you don't get that all the time. But yeah, I just wouldn't want to live in a place that's run by the mob, I don't think. So I wouldn't want Liberland to be run by the mob.
I don't know. I think there's an argument to say that an area run by the mafia would actually be a better place to live than the government.
You can move there, then.
There's an argument that would suggest that the mafia will not harass women and children, and the government doesn't have a problem going after women and children. So, you know, they have a code of honor, I think, in the mafia.
Being neither a woman nor a child, those things are, you know, they're not that...
Well, you have a wife and you have a child, so, I mean, I would think you would be concerned about the freedom of those people. I mean, if I had to choose, I think I would go with the mafia over the government. Anyway, you're welcome to share your thoughts. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You know, the mafia just wants their payoff, and then they leave you alone. The government keeps screwing with you. Let's go on here.
Liberland's success is in no way assured. Croatia has been arresting eager Liberland settlers, and creating an ethnically heterogeneous nation-state without decades of immigration is a tall order. Still, Jelitka believes in the mission.
For me, it's most important to establish really strong international global community of people, like-minded people, who are serious about spreading liberty all around the world. We will have a chance to establish a country there if it's mainly about love and freedom.
Love and freedom. I'm all for that. Let's do that. I hope they. I hope this works out for them. I really do. We're going to be paying as close of attention as we possibly can. But if you've heard Liberland news and we're not talking about it, I want to know. Right. So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That allows you to join the program here. You know, you consider yourself our producer. You can call in and clue us in.
Yeah, I would love to hear more about Liberland any old time.
So, by the way, we also have Skype at Skype username lrn.fm, and that's where Joseph is on the line right now on Skype. Hello, Joseph. Do we have Joseph on Skype? You know what? I've been having some technical difficulties in studio. It's probably not Joseph's fault. I'll see if I can iron those out here in a moment.
Well, there you go.
So not just Liberland on the table to discuss here tonight. There's also some other international news with North Korea putting people on trial for watching movies. Yes, that's right. It's illegal to watch American films in North Korea, and you'll be sent to a labor camp, which, you know, is not as bad as being murdered, I guess, executed by the government.
Not much better.
Actually, it might be better to be executed by the North Korean.
Those labor camps are horrifying.
Yeah, they're pretty awful. People eating their own feces. I remember hearing stories about a woman eating corn pieces of corn.
Whatever she could find, right?
Still in feces. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, because that's how bad it is at the North Korean labor camps. But anyway, that could be waiting for you if you're in North Korea and watching foreign films. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us here, 855-450-FREE. Plus, good news from Peoria, Illinois. You may recall the story, I believe we talked about this on the air, where a short-order cook named Jonathan Daniel, who is 30 years old, used his Twitter account, he created a Twitter account using the handle @PeoriaMayor. On or around March 12th of 2014, he labeled it as a parody account. Its content ranged from ambiguous to offensive, with repeat references to sex and drug use. According to the Peoria Journal-Star, the actual mayor of Peoria is Jim Artis, who's a Republican. He did not like Jonathan Daniels' funny take mayor account. And on April 15th of 2014, multiple police officers raided Jonathan's home on the pretense of investigating him for the crime of so-called false impersonation of a public official. There's a little bit of good news in this case. We'll share that with you coming up. And you can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE, whether it's your thoughts on Liberland or whatever's on your mind. It goes here on the live Labor Day edition of Free Talk Live.
Ooh, get the stinky dog away from me.
Petey stopped eating. All his hair fell out.
Mounds and mounds of fur. Our hairballs have hairballs.
Bad breath and bad gas.
Chew himself raw. Sticky, gooey, smelly. She scratched incessantly.
At least $5,000 in vet bills.
And all it took was one container of Dynavite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Adding Dynavite to their diet has
every single dog in my kennel looking better than they have ever looked.
The shedding has stopped and the itching has stopped.
Tons of energy. No more bad smell.
She has gotten this puppy look. Her coat has sheen.
Everything we tried failed except the Dynavite.
My vet was completely blown away.
Dynavite's the bomb.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Piedmont Attorney Spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with Whipple Office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Hello, Joseph.
Yes, Ian.
I can hear you now.
Oh, okay. Hey, I got a dash cam story for you. I bought a dash cam off of your website.
Cool. You don't have to tell me the whole story now. Stand by, okay?
Okay.
AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to AlkaVision.com to find out more. That's ALKAVision.com.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233. For the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237.
Hey, Joseph, where are you calling from?
Winchester, Virginia.
Great. Stand by.
All right.
At 800-686-2237.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Aw Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. It's the live Labor Day edition of the program. Of course, you're invited to join us here on the radio waves. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Ian here with you.
And Mark.
And we're going to go right back into your phone calls and thoughts here. Let's go to Joseph. He's on the line in, Virginia on Skype. Hello, Joseph.
Hello, Ian. Hello. Long-time listener, first-time caller.
Welcome.
So I have a great dash cam story for you guys. I got the dash cam from Free Talk Live, the freedomcam.net.
Yeah.
It works like a charm. First time I've ever needed it. I had it for like 2 years. I was in Ocean City, Maryland. But the nice thing about it, I'd like to point out with the Freedom Cam at freedomcam.net is you've had it for 2 years. You didn't have to really do much of anything with it in that period of time. You turn on your car, bring, it comes on, you know, usually about 30 seconds, a couple minutes later. It comes on, sort of boots up.
It doesn't take 2 minutes. It just takes like 30 seconds.
Mine has taken me longer in the past, but 30 seconds maybe.
I run mine perpetually. It's connected to my battery constantly.
So. Oh, wow. So even when you're not in the car, you've got yours running.
You're a bad mamma jamma.
I was stopped at a red light in Ocean City, Maryland, of all places. And I'm just sitting there chilling, listening to my music, and light turns green, and I start to go, and this guy just darts out right in front of me. This is like 10 o'clock at night, and I bumped him just a little bit, knocked him over. And if I didn't knock him over, he would have got hit by a bus next to me. But
whoa.
I think it saved his life, but I didn't hurt him. He got right back up. And then almost instantly, I got out of my car. A cop was on the scene. He was right there. And they, you know, got me to tell this, you know, come over and get my information and everything. The guy was okay, no problem. And I told the cop, I got it on my dash cam. He's like, oh, can I see it? I'm like, sure. And we plugged the SD card into his computer inside the cruiser, and he let me navigate to the file, and he showed it to me. He let me free to go, and the guy got a jaywalking ticket.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, wow.
Right there on the scene, pulled the SD card out.
Well, if that's the choice, I'd rather him get the jaywalking ticket than you get whatever ticket one gets for hitting pedestrians.
So this thing possibly saved you from a ticket or an arrest.
Oh, who knows what could have happened? I mean, this guy could have said, oh, that guy hit me, you know, my word against his. I mean, dash cam saved me, saved my butt big time.
Paid for itself right there. Boom. One shot.
That's what it is. It's the ultimate witness.
That's very cool. Very cool story. Anything else you want to share tonight, Joseph?
Yeah, I also like to share like the vaping. I was in a club down there, and I was vaping inside a club, and they came up to me and showed me a no smoking sign. They're like, no smoking. And I said, I'm not smoking, I'm vaping.
Good news, I'm not smoking.
And I just wanted to know if you guys had any knowledge on the current situation with vaping versus smoking and laws and rules. Are they like, is vaping considered smoking legally? Like in
depends.
Restaurants?
So
it's being considered smoking socially, from what I can tell.
Just socially.
Well, no, it depends on the jurisdiction. So I understand it. There are, I think, is it New York City? I know there are a couple of places. New York City, I think, is one of them where vaping is being treated at the city level as though it is the same thing as smoking. And so there is a push to regulate it in exactly the same manner as cigarettes. But in other places, that hasn't happened yet. Of course, as we've seen in New York and California over the years, a lot of other states will essentially ape what they do if New York and California are successful.
They can get away with it.
At getting away with oppressing people's ability to vape. Vaping is banned from the local courthouse here in Keene, New Hampshire. So we've seen a little bit of it here. But as far as the laws in New Hampshire are concerned, no, there's no prohibition on vaping here yet. And you
it's
know,
just
where
that you, oftentimes if you go to a restaurant, that of course they're going to be like, why, we don't know what to do about this. There's somebody looks like they might be smoking things.
Well, if it's a private property, then you know they can decide to do what they want.
I concur
with that.
But
if it's the Fed or if it's the state government coming down and enforcing a no vaping rule, then that's a huge issue. In fact, I believe there was a proposal about that here in New Hampshire last year, but it did not go through. So the state reps managed to shoot that one down. Here,
yeah, well,
so
a lot of state reps were probably vaping while they shot it down.
It could they could very well have been. Joseph, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Enjoy your vape. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe some of our listeners don't really know the whole vaping phenomenon. I don't know how widespread
it is. It's big, but I think that it's just big in circles. Circles.
Like the vapor folks are really into it. Like they have clubs for vaping. There's like in New England, there's a New England Vapers Association or something like that. And they get together and they meet. I remember they had one of their meetups at the same place once that we had a Freedom meetup. And so it was just a coincidence. We didn't know that was going to happen. And the place was like filled with a cloud of vape. The whole place smelled like fruity fruit.
Yeah.
And it was very pleasant, actually.
Well, I wouldn't say that humans probably wouldn't have evolved in a glycerin-based atmosphere. So it's, you probably shouldn't fill the room full of your vapor, but
I don't know. I mean, it didn't fill the entire room, but there was definitely like a cloud of it near where they were. Like, normally, if somebody's vaping and they're 6 feet
it's
away
a vaping
from you,
event. Yeah.
If someone's 6 feet away from you and you're in a room with that person and they're vaping, you can't even tell.
No.
Unlike somebody smoking a cigarette, when as soon as you walk in the room, you know somebody is smoking a cigarette in the room. And, of course, the vape does not, their vapor does not penetrate like curtains and carpet in the same way that cigarette smoke does. So somebody could be puffing away on their vape all day long in a room in a house. You could come in there later on and you'd have no idea. It's just a completely different
thing. It doesn't, like,
thing.
I bought a house one time where there was a smoker there, and it's just like,
it's the
what
worst.
Do you do about that?
And you got to tear out the carpet, tear out the anything with that can absorb a scent.
I steam cleaned the carpet and aired out the house. I painted all
paint
the walls.
Over the walls, kills the paint that's there, and then paint over it.
So I was able to, you know, I didn't have to burn the place to the ground or anything. But yeah, I mean, it would have been preferable not to have to deal with that.
Exactly. So vaping, you know, there's not a whole lot of medical study that has gone on yet, as I understand it. But initial studies have shown, I think, that the vaping seems like it is safer than the cigarette smoking. Obviously, you don't have a lifetime of studies or anything like that at this point. But
no,
it seems pretty clear that it's better for you.
I've certainly seen people say that the vaping was not good for their lungs, but those people had smoked their whole life, you know, at that point, too. So it's difficult to say. I would say that it seems reasonable that vaping contains like one carcinogenic thing, which is nicotine. Mm. Cigarettes contain like 200. Which one do you want to pick? You know, it seems obvious to me in that
way. Yeah, I mean, I'll go with what the people are saying, right? Like, it's one thing you can have studies that will show you whatever it is you want them to show you. I mean, depending on how you set the study up can sometimes, you know, that can have an effect on the results of the study. But you know, I like it when you get case studies, when people will tell you that, oh, well, when I started vaping, I felt better. Like, I could breathe better after a number of months of vaping as opposed to smoking cigarettes. And when a cigarette smoker, a longtime cigarette smoker, is swearing by this thing as this has made my life better, that's enough for me.
That's a lot of cigarette smokers to swear by it.
Yeah, that's enough for me. That's enough to persuade me that this is an improvement. And unfortunately, government bureaucrats are not persuaded in many cases, and that's why you're hearing, you know, New York City restricting vaping in the same way. And the argument, you know, it's hard for the anti-vaping people to come at it from the perspective that this is worse than smoking because they don't have any evidence of that. So they can't do that. But what they are trying to do is basically liken the appearance of it to smoking. And so therefore, it's bad for children because it looks like it's smoking. And
this encourages smoking.
And it encourages children to start taking nicotine is the idea. Because vapor fluids in a lot of cases have flavorful scents to them and tastes to them. So, you know, cherry and blueberry and
I would encourage everybody who's smoking to vape and everybody who's vaping to stop. That's my encouragement. And for people who don't do either, to not do any of those things. Mm. But I've got to say, as a non-smoker now, I was a smoker, I have vaped and I've enjoyed it. But I don't. It's not something I want to be particularly dependent on. You can get this vape stuff that has no nicotine at all. It's possible to do
that. Yeah, that's true.
So, you know, there you go. That's another issue.
I think it's neat. I'm a fan of it, and of course, it's also something that you're starting to see in the cannabis world as well as cannabis vaporization. And for medical purposes, the cannabis vaporization is like the most or the least objectionable way to deliver the product, basically. I mean, it's a very fast-acting way to deliver your medicine, and it doesn't have the deleterious effects of smoking. And, of course, even with smoked cannabis, they've shown that cannabis seems to be an anti-cancer, like a cancer-fighting agent.
Well, at times, I wouldn't say that I would. You know what? You and your doctor need to decide whether or not cannabis is right for treating your medical condition, whatever that might be. But I wouldn't just go ahead and say, hey, cannabis is going to fix all your problems.
I wouldn't say that, but it has been shown to apparently have some anti-cancer properties, which is pretty exciting. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. That's 855-450-3733. More about the mayor. The fake mayor account in Peoria, the guy who created that, what's happening to him? It's Free Talk Live.
When the leading antihistamine and Nasacort go nose to nose, Nasacort wins, stopping more of the chemical responses that can cause your nasal allergy symptoms. And when you stop more causes, you get 24-hour relief from sneezing, an itchy runny nose, even congestion. It's prescription-strength medicine available over-the-counter. Nasacort allergy 24-hour. Stops more of what makes you miserable. Use as directed.
There comes a time when you need custom embroidered or screen printed apparel for your business, organization, or a special event. Corporate Casuals has been helping people create great looking logoed apparel for over 25 years. They can produce a single piece or thousands using name brand apparel like Nike, Patagonia, Adidas, and Hanes. Create your logo in their online embroidery design studio or upload your existing logo and they'll turn it into embroidery. Go to corporatecasuals.com/FTL and include FTL in the order notes and save 5% on your order.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows, pause and rewind live TV, even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
You're listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. The migrant crisis over in Europe continues to intensify, with thousands seeking asylum from murder and mayhem in places such as Syria, Libya, and Iraq. Humanitarian worker Mark Wade says the refugees at a camp in Hungary are frightened and desperate to start a new life.
We've seen family members killed by the Taliban and by ISIS. One young lady fled for her life because she's got an education. Her sisters have been killed, her parents because they worked for the government. So it's thousands of sad stories, unfortunately.
British Prime Minister David Cameron tells Parliament his country must do its part in response to the European migrant crisis.
We are proposing that Britain should resettle up to 20,000 Syrian refugees over the rest of this Parliament.
Cameron said vulnerable children and orphans will be given priority. Attorneys for the Kentucky clerk jailed last week because of a refusal to issue marriage licenses to homosexual couples say they have filed an emergency motion they hope will result in Kim Davis's freedom. The filing seeks to have Kentucky Governor Steve Beshear accommodate Davis's religious conviction and not compel her to grant licenses to homosexual couples. Members of the law enforcement community across Illinois and the rest of the country met in Antioch, Illinois today to say goodbye to Lieutenant Charles Glinowitz, who was slain chasing three unidentified men through Fox Lake, Illinois last Tuesday. Joliet Police Officer Rachel Smithberg says Police Lieutenant Charles Joseph Glinowitz was courageous.
He was the kind of man that in the face of danger would run towards it while others ran away.
Police are still searching for suspects. Glinowitz, a married father of four sons, was a 30-year veteran of the police department. His wife, Mel, wore a police badge on a necklace during the service where her husband's coffin was draped in an American flag. Attendees included Illinois Governor Bruce Rauner. More on these stories at townhall.com.
I just sneaked into my kids' rooms and took temperatures while they're sleeping, thanks to my Exergen thermometer. All I did was swipe their foreheads for a few seconds. It didn't even wake them up. My sister, the nurse, told us about the Exergen temporal scanner thermometer, and it's the best. Real value for the money and truly a lifesaver. Now I don't have to deal with ears or rears, if you know what I mean.
I'm Dr. Frank Pompei, founder of Exergen. Thousands of hospitals and clinics rely on temporal scanners. I'm confident you will too.
The Exergen temporal scanner. Pick one up at Costco and other fine retailers, or visit us at Exergen.com.
Got a lot on your to-do list? Now, during Kubota's Power to Do Great Things sales event, get a great deal on an L3301 or 3901 tractor with a live continuous running rear PTO. Now get financing as low as 0% APR for up to 5 years, and great customer instant rebates when you buy a new L3301 or 3901 and two implements. Now through September 30th, 2015. Call toll-free 1-888-465-8268 for details about cost and terms.
For more information or to find a participating dealer, visit Kubota.com.
A new study of whooping cough in infants prompts a new recommendation to boost vaccination rates among pregnant women. Details from correspondent Linda Kenyon.
Researchers say pregnant women who are vaccinated can transfer some of the protection against the disease before the birth of the child. The study of government data finds infants are more likely to catch whooping cough from their siblings than from their moms. So if the children have protection from the disease before they're born, they are more likely not to pick it up from their brothers and sisters.
The study is published in the journal Pediatrics. Martin Milner, star of the popular 1960s TV shows Route 66 and Adam 12, has died. He was 83 years of age. Milner's good looks helped to shoot him to fame in 1960 with Route 66, which featured two young men roaming the highway in a red Corvette convertible. Milner then signed on to another buddy series, Adam 12. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. The Congress is set to vote this week on the controversial Iran nuclear program.
It appears as though President Obama and his supporters have enough votes to pass the nuclear bill, but the controversy continues. Supporters claim this bill will prevent nuclear war in the Middle East. Opponents claim the bill gives billions of dollars to Iran and allows it to build nuclear weapons in 10 years or less. The U.S. will send large amounts of weapons to Israel, Saudi Arabia, and some Gulf nations to maintain balance in the region. There are also hopes Iran will release some U.S. political prisoners once the agreement passes the Congress. Connie Lawn reporting from Washington.
A San Antonio area police department is investigating two football players who rammed into a referee during a high school game. The Northside Independent School District is conducting its own investigation into Friday's incident and has suspended the two players from the school and the team. More on these stories at townhall.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS-80, Guns80.com.
Free Talk Live.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live, live Labor Day edition. Of course, you can dial in toll free and bring up anything you want. And still to come, more on the Peoria man who is who was in trouble for a little while, arrested after a raid on his house on the pretense of investigating him for the crime of false impersonation of a public official for a parody Twitter account. We'll give you the latest on what's happening with his case. We actually had a somebody who's a vapor, somebody who uses an e-cigarette to deliver their nicotine to them. He called in the last hour, and you know, that's just kind of how Free Talk Live goes. We're an open phone show. You can call in and bring stuff up, and then we'll sometimes be interested in that and maybe talk about it further. And that's what's going on here, is because I wanted to see the latest on the e-cigarette legal status. And there is some news here that is not good news for people in Rockland County, New York. So the question was earlier, well, you know, what's the legal status around the United States of e-cigarette use? And of course, the answer is it depends. It depends on the political jurisdiction, the arbitrary boundaries in which you find yourself, what the legal status is. And I remember hearing that New York City was treating e-cigarettes the same as regular cigarettes. I think that's the case there. If I'm wrong about that, please, New York City folk, correct me. But as New York City does, so do other places. And here's the latest from LowHUD.com, Lower Hudson Valley. Rockland County lawmakers have approved extending the county's strict smoking ban to include e-cigarettes. The legislature voted 15-0, not a single dissenting vote in Rockland County. On Tuesday, to lump electronic cigarettes. It's interesting. They're actually calling them the legislature. This is a county government, and they have their own legislature.
I guess.
Normally, you know, it's the county commissioners or the city council or the aldermen. I've never heard of a county government having its own legislature before.
Well, it's not inaccurate. It's just, you know, it's not what we're used to hearing.
Yeah. Well, this is New York for you. Anyway, they decided to lump electronic cigarettes, small battery-powered vaporizers that heat liquid nicotine, into existing restrictions on traditional tobacco products. And Westchester County made a similar move in June. So you're starting to see this spread into various different parts of New York State. Legislator Annie Paul from Nanuet, who proposed the bill, said she was concerned about the growing acceptance of e-cigarettes or vaping among middle and high school students. She called it a potential gateway to cancer-causing tobacco.
Well, is it a potential gateway? Yes, that's accurate. It's a potential gateway. But why, you know, I can't imagine there's too many people out there that have gone from nothing to vaping to cigarettes, but I could be wrong.
Yeah, I suspect you're right about that. I imagine the numbers are very, very small. In fact, I suspect the numbers are much larger of people who've gone from tobacco to e-cigarettes and further to nothing than there are those who've gone from nothing to e-cigarettes to tobacco.
Yeah.
She goes on, though. She says, I was worried about the potential health impact on the next generation. You can see it in the middle school students who are starting to use e-cigarettes. According to the U.S. Centers for Disease Control, the number of teens who vape tripled between 2013 and 2014. E-cigarettes contain nicotine-laced liquid that can come in a variety of candy-like flavors, such as bubblegum. Sellers and users have been fuming over the proposed change. They view vaping as a safer alternative to traditional tobacco products, although the science is hazy on how safe the products actually are. Roseanne Sika wrote on LoHud.com back in August, quote, I quit cigarettes and I vape. This is the most ridiculous thing that I have ever seen, unquote.
Yeah, another thing about, it would seem like if you're a legislator, you're worried about the health of your constituency, that you would want to encourage vaping at least over cigarettes, right? So basically now people have to go outside to smoke. And when you're talking about Maryland, is that where it is?
Oh, this is Rockland County, New York.
New York. You're talking about pretty cold winters. Being up here in New Hampshire and having been a smoker at one point, I understand what it's like to have to go outside and smoke. So if I can switch to vaporizing and stay indoors and do that, that's going to be an advantage for me.
Absolutely. The Consumer Advocates for Smoke-Free Alternatives Association urged members to try to block the ban, listing legislators and their phone numbers on its website. Unfortunately, they were completely unsuccessful, as it was a 15-0 vote. Since 2003, Rockland County has had a ban in place on smoking in offices, restaurants, schools, sporting facilities, and county government buildings. So pretty much anywhere indoors, except for your house. Violators of the ban could face a $150 fine for a first violation and $300 for each subsequent violation. So even if you could show these people that vaping is more healthy than smoking, they still would be against it because of the theory that it will make it more likely that children and teenagers will take up smoking. It's like a completely unproven theory.
That's what it's like. Look, there's a person over there that looks like they're smoking. We just can't have that. And that's what it comes down to.
Maybe they should ban candy cigarettes too while they're at it, because those make that little puff of, if you ever have that candy cigarette with a wrapper on it.
Yeah.
There's two types of candy cigarettes. There's the one that's just like the stick, and then there's the one that actually has the piece of paper wrapped over a piece of gum.
Yeah.
That one you can actually blow through and the little confectioner sugar or whatever comes
out
of the end of
it. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, it makes you look cool when you're a kid and you do that.
Yeah, I did have the candied cigarette, the gum cigarettes, but I never blew on them and thought that was cool. Then again, my dad smoked, so.
Here is a man who knows a thing or two about smoking and vaping. He's Michael Dean from the
Excellent.
Freedom Fiends. Hello, Michael. He who has not put his headphones on yet, apparently.
Michael Radio, Michael W. Dean.
Okay, I was worried you butt dialed us or something like that. Hello, Michael.
No. Hey, no, my butt is not sitting on my computer keyboard.
Just
usually
making
it
sure.
Is, but it's not. No. Hey, man. Yeah, vaping will kill you, and I'm here to tell you why.
Okay.
Go right ahead.
Hear my voice. Okay. That's vaping.
It's vaping.
First of all, when I criticize vaping as possibly not entirely 100% safe, liberty people and vaping people jump on me with violent responses in text, screaming at me, saying I'm lying, Like, people are religious about this stuff because it's really cool. Vaping's fun and it's probably safer than cigarettes. And people have convinced themselves that anyone who criticizes it, even if they have anecdotal, you know, self, like how it harmed me information, people think I'm part of the system that's trying to outlaw it. I want to say right up front, I think vaping should be available freely next to heroin and assault rifles in vending machines.
Okay.
I'm not for banning anything.
I think they had that at Porkfest this year.
Yeah, yeah, and they had BIPCOT licenses in there too.
So wait a minute. So, okay, so but wait. Tell us a little more. I mean, you obviously don't
my
sound,
history.
You yeah, you don't sound history. Great for our listeners who don't know. You're the host of one of the hosts, the variety of hosts of Freedom Fiends, which is another great syndicated talk show.
He's basically the CEO of it. He's the organizer of it. At this
point.
I am
now. I used to be the co-host, but I have my throat has been so thrashed.
Yeah.
I haven't called in you guys either. I mean, it's to the point where, like, my health is so bad, partially from vaping, that, you know, like an hour of talking and I go into an asthma fit for a day, you know.
From vaping. So you were also a smoker.
From vaping. Okay, here's my really quick history. Had mild asthma as a kid. After puberty, it got a lot less. Like, that happens a lot. Like, you have it when you're a kid, and then, you know, after puberty, it's like you don't really have a problem with it. And I carried around one of those, like, over-the-counter, you know, inhalers, yeah. the whatchamacallit, primatine mist, and used that, like, a couple times a week. Chain smoked for 30 years, from 18 to 38. I smoked, like, 2 packs of cigarettes a day average for 10 years. I smoked 60-pack years.
Wow, that's a lot of smoking.
18 to 38 is 20 years, yeah.
Which is enough, 30 years times 2 packs, basically. It was, you know, like a pack a day the first decade, 2 packs a day the second decade, 3 packs a day the third decade.
Gotcha. Oh, my
which
God.
Which is enough to give you lung cancer. I mean, literally, like, it's amazing I don't have it, and I don't have it. So, like, 4 years ago, pretty much, I quit smoking and started vaping. Felt better. And chain vaped. I mean, I was probably vaping the nicotine equivalent of 5 packs of cigarettes a day. And that's one of the dangers of it, is that since it doesn't bother your lungs as much, it's possible to do it more. You know,
and some people do.
All right. Stand by. I want to continue the discussion with Michael Dean, who is saying that he believes the vaping contributed to his current deleterious health status. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us, 855-450-FREE. Nobody said that it was safe. It's just probably safer than smoking. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie and let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the sacro wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the sacro wedgie.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free. The number's 855-450-FREE. Your thoughts on vaping? And it seems pretty clear to me that it is not as dangerous as smoking, and I'm pretty sure almost everybody who's ever done it would probably agree with that. Even Michael Dean, who's on the line with us here, and we're going to bring him back from the Freedom Fiends, is acknowledging that it is likely safer than smoking, but he also says that it contributed to a very nasty health situation that nearly killed him very recently. So we're going to get back into that, but I want you to know about ProXPN. If you care about privacy online, you really need to go and get ProXPN. Doesn't matter what device you're using, your smartphone, tablet, desktop computer, laptop, Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux, whatever operating system you're using, ProXPN can encrypt your data connection, meaning that your internet service provider won't have any idea what you're doing online once you start using ProXPN. And ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever. ProXPN also has more servers than ever before, so you get greater speed and security, plus they'll take credit card and even Bitcoin. You can get 50% off of the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy an annual account with code FTL50. That's FTL, like Free Talk Live, and the number 50, as in 50% off. So it can be cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee to protect your privacy. Go to ProXPN.com right now, use code FTL50, and take back the privacy that is your right. It's ProXPN.com, code FTL50. Back to Michael W. Dean. So you smoked a lot of cigarettes for several decades, for at least 3 decades of your life.
Yeah.
You changed it up a few years ago, you said about 4 years ago, to
4 years ago.
Vaping. Yeah. And you started to vape more nicotine in a day.
That's one of the dangers. Yeah, one of the dangers is it enabled me to literally just be sucking on this stuff 24/7. I was chain smoking before, but I was doing it more with stronger nicotine vape and bringing more nicotine into my body. But it wasn't just the nicotine that bothered me. I mean, nicotine is a stimulant. I can handle it. I love nicotine and caffeine. They're my only drugs, and I just, you know, I can take a lot of them. My heart's pretty strong. But so when I quit smoking, I felt healthy. That's the point. Now, I think I'm one of the early, like, patient zero of something that's going to come up a lot in the coming years. And I really hate how when I bring this up anywhere on social networking, people I don't know who are vaping Nazi religious nuts jump down my throat and act like I'm part of the man. Because I'm not trying to outlaw this. I'm just trying to give personal experience. I mean, like Mark said, human life would not have evolved in a glycerin-based atmosphere. We are not meant to breathe in anything except oxygen, you know, or air. So after 3.5 years of smoking stuff, this January, all of a sudden, my lung health failed to the point where, like, I felt like I was drowning. I couldn't walk 30 feet. I couldn't haul the garbage cans out to the street. You know, I was just pretty – I've been a pretty strong, healthy guy for you know, everything I've done in my life up until that point, and my health just failed. And I went to a pulmonologist, and I've been seeing her since, but she didn't really do it for me, so I'm seeing a better pulmonologist starting last week, who I'm really psyched about. But it's not exaggerating saying life-threatening. Like, I've had several life-threatening situations. I've been in the hospital twice. I have coughed so hard I've passed out and broken my nose. Yeah. I've coughed so hard I broke a rib, which I didn't even know was possible, man. That blew my mind. But, you know, this is partially from vaping. Now, when I got off vaping, they had to put me on an oxygen tank 24/7 and have a service come by with tanks and deliver this thing that's called an oxygen concentrator that pulls it out of the air, because I wasn't getting – you can measure it. There's a thing that goes on your finger. If you're below 90%, you are starving for oxygen. And I was at like 85%, which is like you feel like your head is underwater, like now, you're being waterboarded.
Is that because your lungs were coated with residue?
Exactly. It took 2 months of coughing constantly to get enough of that out there to where I didn't have to be on oxygen 24/7. And
oh my God. Are you on at nighttime? Are you still on oxygen right now?
Not all the time, but as needed. And mm-hmm. I'm probably going to have to go on CPAP too, which, because I probably have, which may be unrelated. Well, it's
that?
Not to be confused with CPAC, which is the conservative pack. CPAP is if you have sleep apnea, which means like, you know, you stop breathing for 5 or 10 seconds sometimes when you're sleeping.
Yeah, got it.
Which I have, but it could be unrelated. But a lot of people have that. Also, you know, it's like if you're overweight, that tends to happen too. And I am overweight, but it's largely because the past few years, like, my health has kind of been failing in the background and I haven't noticed it. And I haven't been able to exercise. Like, I'd get on the exercise thing and like do it for a couple of weeks, and then I'd get sick. And, you know, it's because of asthma and smoking and vaping related things. Now,
speaking of being overweight, I can tell you I have never been at I ceased being size 32 about the time I quit smoking, and I haven't gotten back.
Really?
And I don't believe I'm ever going to get back. I mean, it's that I'm that far gone from it. What about weight gains? I mean, it's been, what, 4 months for you?
For me? I'm actually really gained a bunch of weight because they put me on prednisone. Which is over the do you know
pregnancy?
Yeah,
it's a steroid. There's nothing you can offer in this then, apparently.
Yeah, yeah. But, you know, I mean, I used to be like skinny as Derek J when I was his age. But then again, I was shooting heroin and doing sit ups, you know.
All right, so but you're doing better now, it sounds like. I mean, at least a little bit, right? Like,
It's hopeful. But it's like, you know, I mean, I a lot of times have to sleep like sitting up in a recliner. I can't lie down on a bed because after 2 hours I'm choking and coughing from like fluid in my lungs. There's a lot of issues and a lot of things at stake here, but it is life threatening. I want to say, like, you know, like my advice for the youngins is like, don't act like vaping is water. You know, it's not safe. It's probably less safe. It's probably less dangerous than cigarettes if you don't do more nicotine and vape than you did cigarettes. But if you chain vape this stuff in a few years, you're probably going to regret it. And it's probably I was in denial about it. I was like, oh, it's not doing, you know, and just like all of a sudden it got to the point of like critical mass to where I just overnight, it just hit me. And I've been to two pulmonologist experts on lung disease, and they're like, both of them are like, yep, you have asthma. You have something called status asthmaticus, which is like a form of asthma that, like, you know, people get from working in asbestos mines and stuff. It does not respond to asthma inhalers. So like the stuff that normally deals with anybody with asthma, the form of extreme asthma I have does not, is not able, you know, like I do an inhaler and it doesn't help.
And how much of that is cigarettes and how much of it is?
Nobody
I don't
knows.
Know.
There's no way to know.
There's no way to know.
Okay.
Well, I guess we'll find out. It'll be interesting to see. You know, there are certain people. Dale Everett's one of them from Flaming Freedom, one of the former hosts of Flaming Freedom. He actually never smoked cigarettes, and when he started vaping,
I took Mark's advice. If you smoke, go to vaping. If you go to vaping, quit.
Yeah, well, that's what we've seen some people do. That is to sort of whittle down their nicotine intake with the vape, because you can cut down the amount of milliliters worth of nicotine in each bottle that you're getting for the
refills.
But
he's right. Some people go to just essentially they take the oral fixation aspect of it and go whole hog.
They get
these things that look like lightsabers.
Yeah.
And
they're cool, man. Yeah. I mean, they're a lot more fun than cigarettes. You know, like you said, like they don't smoke up the whole house. Yeah. You know,
I think everything about them is better than cigarettes, but I think it's, you know, your case is certainly instructive. And thank you, Michael, for your call. And I hope you feel better sooner rather than later. I know you're looking better. You had an injury due to a fall recently, and you're looking nice in comparison to what you were just a couple weeks ago. So healing. It's good. Congrats.
Yep.
And talk to you soon.
Thanks.
Michael
Take
Dean
care.
From the Freedom Fiends at freedomfiends.com. 855-450-FREE allows you to join us here. Are you one of those people who actually started vaping from nothing? It's Free Talk Live.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor recommended Say Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com. The new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy and get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Hey neighbor, what are you doing digging? You had a heart attack last year.
Oh, I know. I was told no more hard labor.
Then why are you digging?
Well, I've been taking Extendovite. It's been approved to help my heart.
Extendovite? Is that a new drug?
No, not a drug. It's more like an herbal combination made from garlic and cayenne.
Herbal? How can that help?
Well, actually, we've taken herbs for thousands of years, and Extendovite is doing the job for me.
Does your doctor know about Extendovite?
Yeah, my doctor knows, and he said it seems to be working for you, so don't stop taking it. I feel great taking Extendovite. I don't want to stop.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822, or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Do you owe the IRS money? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. There is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call now for your free and confidential analysis. 800-481-3147. Again, that's 800-481-3147. 800-481-3147.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live, the live Labor Day edition of the program. You can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Skype in. Skype username is lrn.fm.
If you're looking for Bitcoin news, the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, and the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem is Bitcoinist.net, the prime online destination for information about the Bitcoin and digital currency industry. Whether you're a beginner or an expert, they've got incredible network statistics, a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin, and much more. The Bitcoinist platform serves the needs of everyone. So it's Bitcoinist.net. That's Bitcoinist.net.
All right, so our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. As we continue with your calls and thoughts here, we've got Libertarian Banker on the line calling from somewhere. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. I want to talk about the comprehensive annual financial reports that were brought up the last two nights.
Sure.
This is a report that is very typical of businesses. I'm sure you guys running a business there probably have an income statement and a balance sheet.
No, I don't do that crap. But I've seen those things before.
Hopefully you're figuring out how much money you're making or losing every month.
Not really.
Because that's important to have as a business. Well, either way, the government and other businesses do this.
Right.
And the comprehensive annual financial report might show a ton of money or a ton of assets sitting there. But the problem is the government has borrowed against all of those assets. A lot of them are to take care of pension liabilities they have. A lot of them are assets they put to the side that they then borrow to finance some of their other activities. So it's not as nefarious, you know, as some of the callers might make it out to be. But the problem is the way that the government obtained those assets was through illegitimate means.
Well, sure, they taxed people and they threatened people in order to get the money that they then used to purchase these investments. And then they complain. I think that you know, it's true that the comprehensive annual financial reports are not hidden. You can go and find them, and you can request them, and you can read over them. But they're not generally talked about. Like, the politicians don't mention them. They talk about the budget. They talk about how the budget hasn't, they're spending more than what's on the budget, and they need to raise taxes because of that. But all the while they're complaining about not having enough money in their budget, there's a boatload of money sitting in this comprehensive annual financial report, as well as assets that could be converted.
And like I said, there is a ton of money sitting there, but they've borrowed against it. The money has already been spent and spoken for, you know, so... They just went ahead and took it and borrowed it. And one of the worst is the federal government. When you look at the Social Security program, they wanted to make sure to invest this in a safe investment. And what do they pick? They pick T-bills, which is basically loaning the government back their own money. So they took it from the left pocket to put it in the right pocket. That makes absolutely no sense to me.
And they're charging themselves interest. They're charging you interest.
Exactly. When you say they've borrowed against the stuff on their comprehensive annual financial report, how can they borrow against I mean, I'm not an expert with finances or whatever, but how do you have a bunch of money in investments in stocks and things like that and then borrow against that?
Well, because, okay, so, if you work for the government, you probably have a little bit taken out of your check every month that goes to some sort of retirement system or pension plan. Well, they invest that money in the pension plan, so they owe that money to an individual. So technically, when it's collected, it's borrowed in that sense. Another thing that they do, a lot of things on there are real estate. So they'll get financing in the form of bonds or other financing they can get on the financial market to finance those projects. So the asset, just like if you owned a house at $300,000 and you borrowed $250,000 against it, you know, you will really only own the 50,000 of that. So there might be $1 billion sitting there in a municipality, but only, you know, 200 million of it is actually liquid or available to use.
Well, sure. I mean, but they could sell the buildings or whatever, and they could, there's like here in Keene, New Hampshire, the county government or the city government has a bunch of properties that they just sit on, and they just, you know, they just own it, and then it just sits and rots. There was one of the, there was like a, an old theater building they had in downtown Keene that just got gutted recently because it had just been sitting there under the care of the local government, and they just basically let it sit there and rot away.
And absolutely, because they have no incentive to do anything with that building because they could steal your money from you, and that gets back to my point of...
Well, they could actually... They could have an incentive to do something with it. Like, in theory, right, a government would want a building to be occupied so they could charge the owner of it property taxes. But if the government itself is the owner of the building, then they're not charging themselves property taxes on the property. So, in theory, there could be an incentive there, but because they're government, they're not incented to move quickly on doing any of these things.
Exactly, exactly. So thank you for your time tonight,
hey,
guys.
Hey, thanks, Banker. I appreciate hearing from you. We got Jeff in Illinois. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Jeff.
Hi, guys. Someone before was had some issues where he's having fluid in his lungs. A lot of times fluid respiratory issues are created by digestive problems. And so some detoxification may be in order there. So people could look up that and figure out what to do in that respect. As far as the bankers go, when the English surrendered the sword to George Washington, they promised they'd be back in the Bank of England, you know. So the Federal Reserve is not the government. They're private, and they're basically not very good people at all, you know. And they do all the stuff that's bad that's happening when someone's 401k turns into a 201k or a 101k. The money went somewhere. It didn't just disappear. They make it sound like it just vaporized. But no, it went into somebody's pocket, and it wasn't by accident. It was all planned.
See, I've been looking into this as the idea as to whether or not if a stock loses value, somebody loses money and somebody gains money. And the best I can tell is that wealth is actually destroyed when the value of things go down. So if the if the stock market goes down in value from 17,000 to 15,000, then and that's just the Dow, but whatever, then actually that much value has been destroyed. It's just not there any longer.
I believe that went into somebody's pocket, and if you look hard enough, you might be able to find who it is.
Well, I have yet to be able to figure that out.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Jeff. Appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Remainder of the story about the Peoria Mayor parody account on Twitter. It was at Peoria Mayor. And it was in 2014 when the man who was running it, a short order cook named Jonathan Daniel, was arrested and had his home raided on the pretense of him investigating him. Actually, was he arrested? Oh, excuse me. He was not home at the time. So no charges filed against him. But they raided his house while he was not there and essentially looked for supposed evidence of him impersonating a public official. The police chief at the time had said of the account, which, again, was labeled with the word parody, quote, "It appears that someone went to great lengths to make it appear that it was actually from the mayor," unquote. Daniel wasn't at home
by
at the time.
By posting in a Twitter account that said parody.
Daniel wasn't home at the time of the raid. Oh, okay, they did arrest him at the restaurant at which he worked, but no charges were filed. So he sued the city on the grounds that, legally speaking, it appears to be run by a gang of dopes who wouldn't know the First Amendment from a hole in the ground. On Wednesday of last week, the New York Times reported the city announced that it would pay $125,000 of taxpayer dollars to Daniel to settle his case. Because it's not the police chief. $125,000.
Nice.
To settle this case. The Times wrote, quote, "The city said it believed that it would have ultimately won in court."
That's why they gave the guy $125,000.
Yeah. We would have won this, but, you know, we'd rather not go to court. So yeah. Here's some money.
We're going to harass anybody else out there because we can. And if they somehow go after us for it, then we'll just give you taxpayers' money there. Give them your money. Too bad.
Just what an absolute outrage. And even if the account didn't say parody on it, who cares? He's a public official. Public officials do not have the same level of privacy expectations as do other people. Now, I'm not an attorney, so I can't, you know, say for sure or anything. This isn't legal advice. But that's my understanding of, you know, being able to use a public person's name.
Well, whoever ordered this raid is the one who should have to pay, not the taxpayers of the city of Peoria.
Yeah, sadly, the police chief and the mayor will not be on the hook for this. They are, you know, waltzing off into the sunset in order to do it again to somebody else. 855-450-FREE allows you to join us here on Free Talk Live.
For P150, P150GA, P150LK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100, and things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company, 1-800-809-5580. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away, so you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-809-5580. That's 1-800-809-5580. 1-800-809-5580.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
I am a 47-year-old female and had a heart attack in 2005. This is Alice from New Jersey. I still get angina, even with four stents. I was taking nitro two or three times a week. The very first day after taking heart and body extract, the chest pain was gone. Now I don't wear a nitro patch.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
Quantitative easing, unemployment at depression levels, Europe financial system falling apart, China getting out of U.S. treasuries. At the end of 2008, the time of TARP, the national debt was at $11 trillion, gold trading around $850 per ounce. Close to 2012, the national debt exceeded $16.4 trillion, gold doubled to $1,600 per ounce. The $20 trillion threshold for the national debt is inevitable. Politicians in Washington have a ferocious appetite for spending and stimulus. What's worse, a printing press to finance. 100 years ago, we had a gold standard to limit this madness, but now you have to adopt your own gold standard. Don't be fooled with paper promises. Get Midas Resources 10 Reasons to Buy Gold free by calling 800-686-2237. Understanding the gold and silver market may be the only insurance you could have to avoiding the next economic crisis. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order your free copy. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't pick on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! It's Free Talk Live, the live Labor Day edition of the program. You may take control of the airwaves here and bring up anything that you want. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. With you in studio, it's me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And you can join us via Skype. That Skype username, lrn.fm. So feel free to reach out to us and connect that way if you don't mind. You'll generally sound better if you do. We had been discussing vaping and the continuing crackdown in various different places. Seems like New York is the real hot spot for attacking the vape community, the people who have chosen to use e-cigarettes.
What a surprise. The Empire State is cracking down on everything.
Yeah, according to the story over at lohud.com, Rockland County's legislature, they got their own legislature there in the county, voted 15-0 to include electronic cigarettes into the traditional tobacco ban in various different businesses and restaurants and basically any office, restaurant, school, sporting facility, or government building. So essentially anywhere except for your own house that is indoors, it is prohibited in Rockland County. Also, Westchester County made a similar move in June, and I don't know how many of the other counties in New York have done the same thing, but I imagine you're going to see more of those dominoes falling over time in New York. Other places, your mileage may vary. If you want to check in here and let us know what the status is where you live of these vaping bans, the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and they're usually based on fear-mongering around the idea that children are going to start vaping, and then that will somehow, and I'm not sure how this is, it will somehow lead them to smoking cigarettes. Maybe the idea is that they want to get a bigger hit off of the nicotine, and so they figure the tobacco would be, maybe one of their friends tells them, hey, the cigarettes are better than those vapes, and they'll give them one of those instead.
We can't have freedom, something, something, the children. You know, I mean, that's
pretty much it. Yeah,
but every time.
There's good news about the e-cigarettes as well. A UK report, according to CNN, says that they're safer. The question of whether e-cigarettes can help people quit smoking is hotly debated. Studies looking at the effectiveness of the devices as cessation aids have been unclear, but at best, they suggest that they work about as well as nicotine patches. And they taste better, too. If it's true that they work as well as the nicotine patch, it's certainly more pleasant, I think, to use an e-cigarette than a cigarette.
Well, it also helps with the oral fixation early on.
That's true, because quitting smoking can be difficult for people if they just quit cold turkey because they want to put something in their mouth. So some have suggested like a stick of gum or a sunflower seeds or something like that instead of a cigarette. That's that oral fixation you were talking
right
about, the hand-to-mouth kind of, I guess, addiction, if
something
you will
to do, yeah.
The uncertainty of surrounding the use of e-cigarettes, also known as vaping, did not stop a government body in the U.K., a government body, from concluding in a new report that e-cigarettes could help people quit smoking. The report, published by Public Health England, stated that e-cigarettes are 95% safer than normal cigarettes and that the public health opportunities of these devices should be maximized.
So let's go through this one more time. A UK government organization,
that's correct,
has floated a study. The study says that they are 95% better.
This is a report, not a study, so I suspect they looked at different studies.
Okay, report, and say exactly what they said, 95%?
95% safer than normal cigarettes.
So 95% is a funny number in this circumstance. If they were 100% safer, they'd be twice as safe as cigarettes. Does that make sense?
No.
So they are not 20 times safer from what they're saying
here.
So if you have $1 and I have $2, I have 200% the money that you have.
Yes.
If I have $1 and you have $1, that's 100% of the money. So in this circumstance, if they say they're 95% safer, that means that they're only twice as safe as cigarettes, which is still safe, but do you get what I'm coming
from? No, I still don't get it. You're going to have to explain that one to me off the air.
Okay.
How is 95% twice as safe? That doesn't make sense to me.
Well, it'd be nearly twice as safe. How's that?
100% safer than normal cigarettes. Okay, somebody else will have to explain that to me. I don't have time to really think
about
that.
I'm just trying to understand what it says here, and that's what my understanding of it is.
Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, the authors of the report recommended that a range of prescription-based e-cigarette options be available, and there are for nicotine replacement therapies. I agree with the UK, which is that they are going to medically license e-cigarettes and make them available in the context of smoking cessation aids, according to the dean of Georgia State University School of Public Health, where they are...
Oh, good. So now kids have to start smoking in order to be able to get their vape, their piece of paper to vape. All right.
He says, I think the report is overstating the evidence that e-cigarettes are a miracle for cessation. These devices do appear to help people quit about as much as nicotine replacement therapies do, yet most smokers are still not successful at quitting, he said. For those who use e-cigarettes as a cessation aid, the goal is for them to switch entirely to the products and then to eventually give them up too. And the one of the study's commenters here says that that would be a major public health accomplishment. Said Erickson, many people who are so-called dual smokers use both tobacco and electronic cigarettes, and it's unclear whether eventually they will phase out the former. Because of the level of nicotine in the e-cigarettes, quitting could be just as tough as giving up the regular kind. Well, there's no doubt, right? Like, you are talking about an addictive chemical.
Right, these are magic.
Yeah. You still have to have willpower. You know,
some,
in order to do
a
this.
Little bit, but yeah. I've seen a lot of people who couldn't quit smoking. Look, I tried to quit smoking quite a few times, and I had to have help, and that was all there was to it. And I've seen people try to quit many times, but they were able to do it with the e-cigarette. So that's a big benefit. When I quit, I use Chantix, which is this drug that, and one of the side effects is it causes people to have vivid dreams. I have vivid dreams anyway, so it didn't really seem to bother me much, but nonetheless.
Sounds good to me. I mean, why wouldn't you want vivid dreams?
Usually they're not pleasant.
Oh, so nightmares is what you mean by that.
Yeah.
That's a little different. There are no federal regulations in the United States, said Erickson. Everybody is waiting on the FDA. If e-cigarettes did become licensed in the United Kingdom, it could make them safer because there will be more regulation of the ingredients. So apparently they're available, Mark, but now they're talking about having some licensing.
Oh, sure. Let's put them behind the counter, behind glass.
The upside for companies would be they could make claims about their product being a smoking cessation aid, which they cannot currently do, I guess. To date, no e-cigarettes have been licensed in the UK, although the new report does encourage that. And the Obama administration in the U.S. has requested the authority to regulate the products like regular cigarettes. The U.K. and European Union are farther ahead, and the U.S. could follow what they have done. The EU regulations include a ban on advertising e-cigarettes and a requirement that the products have health labels. Many states in the United States have rules about where people can vape and rules that prevent the sale of e-cigarettes to minors. There is concern about whether it's more appealing to adolescents with all of the flavors that are involved. They are saying here that the use of e-cigarettes among high school students in the U.S. has tripled from 4.5% in 2013 to 13% in 2014. It's not quite tripling, but that's, you know, close. In that time, the use grew among middle schoolers from 1% to 4% on the e-cigarettes. But what they're not showing you is if that is affecting the amount of cigarette smoking in these high schoolers. Like, would these high schoolers have taken up cigarettes instead of the e-cigarettes if cigarettes were the only option? And we don't know that, right? Because we can't compare apples to oranges in this case. These are young people who have started on using vaporizing. We don't know if they used cigarettes before they started using the vaporizer or if they just started using the vaporizer from nothing. So we don't get any of that information with these statistics. And that's useful information to have when really looking at this as a supposed problem.
Because indeed,
if it turns out that high school students are actually stepping down as adults are with cigarettes by using e-cigarettes, you know, if they'd started smoking, a girlfriend of mine had started smoking at a very, very young age, and unfortunately she has been unsuccessful at switching to the e-cigarettes, but if a young person is successful at switching to an e-cigarette, again, that doesn't come into these numbers. That person would be included in the numbers of the people who are using e-cigarettes at a young age, but it doesn't say whether or not they're actually better off because of it. And I suspect that they are. Our toll-free number for you to join us here with your e-cigarette experience is 855-450-FREE. And there's a fear-mongering piece going around right now on the news headlines. Google News has a bunch of these different stories with ridiculous headlines like this. Survey: high school students using vaping technology to smoke pot. Now, you know, when you've got a headline like that, you are dealing with someone who doesn't know what they're writing about. They have no idea what it is that they're actually writing an article about here, because you can't say that someone is vaping to smoke. One does not go with the other.
And pot sort of indicates like leafy substance as opposed to getting THC from a vaporizer.
Yeah, so there's a lot of confusion in these stories. I've got one here from the from USA Today. You're welcome to share your thoughts, although on whatever you want to discuss at 855-450-FREE. Plus, the FBI apparently has admitted to infiltrating the Burning Man Festival.
Oh, boy.
They're looking for terrorists.
They're burners.
Yeah. It's Free Talk Live.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Gary? Why aren't you outside enjoying the party?
Hey, Michelle. It's this heartburn. When it hits, it really hits hard.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's it. I've had it. I'm gonna kick acid with Rolaids.
Rolaids Advanced goes to work instantly for powerful relief of your worst heartburn, bloating, and gas.
Wow, you're back fast.
Yeah, I feel much better. Now this is a party.
Kick acid and gas with Rolaids Advanced.
Honey, why are there fish swimming in our bathtub?
Aren't they cute? You need more omega-3s, and those fish oil pills with toxins and heavy metals are scary. So I'm making fish oil from scratch.
Oh boy, didn't I tell you I'm ordering Nutrigold fish oil? It's exceptionally pure.
That's what they all say.
No, really. Nutrigold's fish oil is concentrated from pure cold water fish straight off the Alaskan coast and manufactured right here in the USA.
Well, cold Alaskan waters are much more pristine than the polluted waters that other fish oils are sourced from.
That's what I'm saying. And it's five-star certified to meet international purity, potency, and freshness standards.
Well, that sounds even better.
Great. I'll be in my office ordering a few bottles. If I order now on www.fishoil.best, I can save $5 using the promo code MyFishOil. Honey, why are there bees in my office?
Get rid of those fish burps for good. Go to Nutrigold's U.S.-made fish oil products by going to www.fishoil.best and get $5 off by entering MyFishOil at...
This is the Genesis Communications Network, GCN.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. On this Labor Day, President Obama signed an executive order mandating 7 days of sick leave for employees of federal contractors.
I'm calling on Congress, take a cue from the rest of the world. Work together in a bipartisan fashion. Find a way to make paid leave, paid family and medical leave a reality for all Americans. That's something we should be doing.
President Obama spoke in Boston today to a major union rally. The huge migration into Europe continues, with thousands pouring into Austria and Germany from migrant camps in Hungary and Serbia. Humanitarian worker Mark Wade says migrants and refugees sheltered at the camp in Hungary are from many different countries.
The Horn of Africa, North Africa, obviously the Syrians and the Iraqis and the Afghanis are very traumatized.
France has agreed to take in 24,000 refugees over 2 years, part of 120,000 refugees that the European Union wants to place. Congress returns to Washington tomorrow after a long summer recess. Correspondent Linda Kenyon has the story.
The list is long and the time is short. Congress has to pass a bill on the Iran nuclear deal, a long-term highway funding bill, and a bill to keep the government operating after September 30th. Failure to pass the government funding bill could lead to a government shutdown, something the GOP leadership says it hopes to prevent.
Also during the month of September, a high-profile visit of the Pope, who will speak to a joint session of Congress on the 24th. Attorneys for Kentucky clerk Kim Davis, who was jailed last week because of her refusal to issue marriage licenses to homosexual couples, say they have filed an emergency motion with a federal court that they hope will result in Davis's freedom. The filing seeks to have Kentucky Governor Steve Beshear accommodate Davis's religious conviction. More on these stories at townhall.com.
I don't like sit-down dinners, I don't go to sit-down strikes. I like standing room only, and I don't ride bikes.
This pretty bad song is by a guy with pretty bad hemorrhoids. He needs Preparation H relief with the power of two. First, use fast-acting Preparation H medicated wipes, then longer-lasting Preparation H maximum strength cream.
Let's sit together on the porch swing.
Preparation H, don't stand for hemorrhoids. Use as directed.
And try specially formulated medicated wipes for women.
If you're one of the millions of Americans who suffers from back pain, there's new hope for relief without the use of over-the-counter pain pills. Australian Dream, makers of the popular arthritis cream, now offers a back pain cream. It's real medicine that goes on fast and provides effective relief for simple backache. Australian Dream back pain cream has no odor, doesn't burn, and isn't greasy. And it's backed by the empty jar guarantee. Love it or send back the empty jar for a full refund. Find Australian Dream back pain cream now.
The U.S. Air Force is warning the owners of a remote Nevada property surrounded by a vast bombing range to accept $5.2 million or see the property condemned by the government.
The owners include descendants of a couple who lost their hardscrabble mining enterprise after the Air Force moved in the 1940s. Nuclear testing then began in 1951. Their mine mill mysteriously exploded in 1954, and they ran out of money to seek reparations from the government in 1959. Family representatives say the site is a symbol of their grandparents' and great-grandparents' blood, sweat, and tears, and they'll be giving the deal a thumbs down for now. Bob Agnew reporting.
A San Antonio school district suspended two football players from the team and from school after one of them ran into the back of a referee and the other dove into the fallen official. Video shows the referee's head snapping back when he's leveled from behind. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. National Hurricane Center specialist Daniel Brown says Tropical Storm Grace is moving west across the Atlantic Ocean.
Grace is located over the eastern Atlantic, about 685 miles southwest of the Cape Verde Islands. It's moving to the west at about 16 miles per hour and has maximum winds of about 50 miles per hour.
Brown says little change in strength is expected during the next day or so, and gradual weakening of Grace is expected afterwards. Meanwhile, in the eastern Pacific, Hurricane Linda is gaining strength. Linda's maximum sustained winds increased to near 85 miles an hour, with additional strengthening expected. But weakening on Linda is expected to begin on Tuesday. That hurricane is centered about 440 miles south-southwest of the southern tip of Mexico's Baja California Peninsula and is moving northwest near 14 miles an hour. More on these stories at townhall.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24-7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
This is Free Talk Live. Of course, you can join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
And it is the live Labor Day edition of the program. And I should add that it is our officially ninth full year in New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project.
We did. We moved on Labor Day weekend back in 2006.
That's right.
We did the Saturday show. And then
in Florida.
We, at 10 o'clock when we went off the air, we immediately began packing up the studio.
Right.
Put it all in a U-Haul truck. Began packing up my house and your house by the morning
time. The truck was already packed with others, I think your house was already packed, and most of my stuff was already packed there.
We left in the morning, though.
Yeah, basically we were packing the studio afterwards, and then drove straight all the way through to New Hampshire, about a 26-hour drive to get here.
And then we were back on the air on Monday.
Nope, that's not true. We were back on Tuesday. There were some technical difficulties that actually prevented us from going back on Monday. And that was at the time when we did not have a Sunday show. So we went off the air Saturday night and we're back on from New Hampshire that following Tuesday. So it has now been approximately 9 years to the day since we started our show here in New Hampshire, or continued doing our show here in New Hampshire. We moved here as part of the Free State Project, which is, in my opinion, still your best chance at achieving liberty in your lifetime. I wrote up a little summary piece over at freekeen.com today about just sort of why things are so great here in New Hampshire for those who actually care about the ideas of freedom, some of the success stories. I mean, we've covered a lot of news here on Free Talk Live that has come out of New Hampshire over the near decade that we've been on the air from here. And, you know, we still have not even scratched the surface on all of the activism that is going on here. And as I point out in the story over at freekeen.com, the people in New Hampshire are great. I mean, the natives here are generally more liberty-oriented in New Hampshire than people in a lot of other places. There is that live-free-or-die mentality. Even though the state is here and the state is oppressing peaceful people in a variety of different ways, New Hampshire has its issues. For instance, we're behind the ball on the issue of gun carrying and cannabis legalization. So, you know, New Hampshire is not as free as Vermont or Maine when it comes to carrying a weapon concealed without a permit. You can do that in Vermont.
Does Maine have constitutional carry?
Maine just passed it this year. I don't know if it's gone into effect there or not, but it's been passed.
It was close on in New Hampshire, too, and we'll see whether it goes through this next go-round.
It was close, but the governor pledged to veto, so that didn't happen. It's probably not going to happen in the next year, but maybe the next term if we can get some new politician in there instead. And so that's an issue. And then, you know, there's some other issues. New Hampshire could be a more friendly business environment, and so there's a lot to work on here. This is a project. The idea isn't you move to New Hampshire.
Still among the freest places on the planet.
Arguably the freest place in the United States, arguably one of the freest in all of the entire world. And also there are now over 17,000 people who are signed to come to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. And over 1,800 are already here. So over 1,500 of them have actually moved. There was a couple hundred that were here already once the Free State Project chose New Hampshire as its destination. There were 10 candidate states from which to choose. New Hampshire overwhelmingly just walloped the rest of the states in a vote that happened with the first 5,000 members of the Free State Project. Once New Hampshire was chosen, however, the momentum behind the Free State Project basically came to a screeching halt. There had been a
I think that the fantasy of the Free State Project really got people excited about it. And once the reality of, oh, we're going to have to move to a particular place and actually do this stuff, then the rubber hits the road and people who are really going to do something, that's my take on it.
Well, anyway, it had slowed down and it has been slow going ever since. It's been more than a decade since, I mean, we've been here for almost a decade, but it's actually been since 2003, late 2003, since New Hampshire was chosen. People have been moving ever since that time. And so, you know, it's slow going trying to convince people to make the move, to pick up their lives, their families, their businesses, and to come to a new place. That's a tough pitch, even for people who are principled libertarians. Because it's expensive and it's, you know, it's a task. You're leaving your family in a lot of cases and friends and your networks that you've and whatever roots that you've put down in other places. So it's a big commitment of people to move up here.
Yeah, 1,800 people have, though.
About 1,500 are actually the early movers.
Well, 1,826 in state.
Correct. Because there were about 275 that were already in New Hampshire when New Hampshire was chosen as the Free State Project.
I'd also like to point out that there's over 2,500 in state friends of the Free State Project.
That's a big deal, yeah.
So there's about 4,000 people in state for the Free State Project if you want to count it that way.
Yeah, I think you could count it that way because those friends are people who have taken the time to actually go and sign up as a friend on the website. And so there are even more people in New Hampshire that are liberty friendly who haven't done that too, right? So the numbers should be even higher than that. But nonetheless, we got over 17,000 people who've signed up for the Free State Project, and we want to reach 20,000. That's the ultimate goal here. At the current rates of signups, we're probably going to see 20,000 in a couple years, probably within 2 years from now. I mean, maybe it'll pick up towards the end. Maybe we'll see a real shooting,
nice.
A shooting up of the sign-up rate. And you never know who's going to tweet or Facebook share. You know, Penn Jillette gets out there and shares the Free State Project. That might,
you
know, spurn a few extra signers. So, but there's some really important things that have happened here in New Hampshire that would not have happened had the early movers not moved like you and I did, Mark. And early movers are still coming. If you move tomorrow, you're an early mover for the Free State Project because it hasn't reached its goal of 20,000 yet. But the early movers for the Free State Project have already built a ton of liberty activist infrastructure, including activist clubs. So in Keene, Manchester, the Seacoast, and Concord, there are physical locations that activists can come to plan activism and to socialize with one another and to enjoy each other's company and, you know, network. There are lobbying and political action groups that have been formed here. The New Hampshire Liberty Alliance, of course,
right.
is a
That would
great
be the
example.
First thing that I would say is the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance has been created. There's no other organization like it in 49 states or, frankly, any other place around the world. The New Hampshire Liberty Alliance is singular, and it's probably I've said it at their benefit, and I don't mind saying it here. I think the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance is the most important organization in the world.
It's certainly the most important organization in New Hampshire for achieving liberty in our lifetime. I'll certainly give you that.
The Free State Project is bringing people in, but at this point, I think we've got all the movers we need to make New Hampshire freer into the future. I'd love to have more, and
yeah.
that process will speed up, and all those people that move will have the benefit of all the work that's been done up to this point by
right.
people who've been in state for more than 10 years now.
Yeah, that's what I'm pointing out here, is that those early movers have created this infrastructure that a new mover can come in, and they don't have to start from scratch. They can just plug into something. You want to do jury nullification outreach? You can do that. There's the nhjury.com and Rights Brigade that are going out and they're spreading jury nullification information all around the state. So you don't have to start from scratch. These things are already happening. You just add your ideas, add your energy into that mix. Dozens of Free State Project early movers have been elected to the state house and also to other positions around the state. So like school board, for instance, there are Free Staters in those positions as well.
I bet you're getting into hundreds have been in elected to positions.
I don't know about that. I would not feel safe making that claim. But going on, other early movers have created various liberty media like ourselves and dozens of other shows that have been created over time. Television, radio. There's even a newspaper that our own Daryl W. Perry, who he kind of is a one-man newspaper operation. He edits and prints and distributes it. So there's a lot of media that's happening here. In fact, I dare say there's more media in New Hampshire, more liberty media, than probably the rest of the world combined. From outreach and civil disobedience projects to state house testimony, Free State Project early movers and New Hampshire natives are active across the state and making a difference for freedom. Numbers and concentration make all of the difference. So if you are part of the liberty movement, if you consider yourself a fan of freedom, if you're a Ron Paul supporter, for instance, this is the place you really ought to be. And if you're not here yet, you should really ask yourself what's holding you back. If you haven't yet signed up for the Free State Project, what are you waiting for? That's the easy part. You go to freestateproject.org. There's a sign-up link on the top right-hand side of the page. Just click that and get signed up for the Free State Project. Start making your plans to join us here in New Hampshire because, really, the fun has just gotten started. I mean, we've had a lot of progress with just 1,000-something, 1,500 people that are here. Imagine 10,000. Imagine what 10 times the activists could do here and
big,
will
big
do.
Deal.
So there's more Free Talk Live. We want you to join us. It's Free Talk Live.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies.
For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
No! That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767.
Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor, period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2 per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
My name's Clyde, age 59, and I reside in Florence, South Carolina. The doctors diagnosed me as having clogged arteries. It felt like I was carrying heavy concrete blocks around my feet and legs. I started taking Heart and Body Extract as directed. It is less than 3 weeks, and I'm like a young man again. It's unbelievable that an herbal formula can work so fast and so powerfully.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
Now, more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us here on the radio waves and talk about whatever's on your mind, from e-cigarettes to freedom of speech on Twitter. You can talk about whatever you want. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio tonight, you do have Ian.
And Mark.
And also, I want you to join us online where you can get interactive with other Free Talk Live listeners. You can help support the show by amping Free Talk Live. You go to amp.freetalklive.com. AMP stands for advertise, market, and promote. It's $5 a month. That's all we ask for, and that is something you can do with any major PayPal, any major credit card through PayPal. You can also use Visa and MasterCard right there on our site at amp.freetalklive.com, and you'll get perks. You'll get access to the AMP-only Facebook group, the AMP-only podcast, and more. And it really makes a big difference for us, because that $5 a month is what we can use to market the show by advertising to radio stations, by calling them directly, talking to program directors, inviting them to sample Free Talk Live and possibly add it to their lineup, going down to New York City once a year and schmoozing it up at the talk radio conference put on by Talkers Magazine. These are all things that are made possible by your $5 a month at the AMP program.
I think I'd like to point out, Ian, this is the Free Talk Live has got to be the only live radio program that's being produced, a commercial live radio program that's being produced, at least a nationally syndicated one today. Maybe there's another, and God bless them if there are. But, you know, I mean, the AMP program makes that possible, too, to some extent. We, you know, somebody's got to incentivize board ops and these sorts of things, and that makes program directors.
Yeah, we're actually giving our board op a bonus tonight for helping us out.
Absolutely.
On Labor Day.
And that makes program directors really happy when they see somebody who is in here doing the show 365 days a year. We're here on Christmas and Thanksgiving and Labor Day, and you pick the holiday, we're here.
Yep.
So that's another thing that your AMP dollar does.
Yeah, and thanks to Patrick over at GCN for running the show tonight. Really appreciate him being there. You can join us at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. So I did mention, there was this fearmongering article. We've been talking about the vapes, the e-cigarettes here tonight, and there's now a fearmongering piece that's gone all over the news as though this is like some sort of revelation that teenagers are using e-cigarettes to what they claim vape marijuana. And here's a story from USA Today, which doesn't have as ridiculous of a headline as the one that I read earlier, which said that they're using vaping to smoke pot, which, of course, you can't
smoke
vape. You can't vape smoke. Vaping is vapor. Smoking is smoke. And those are two different things. Now, I didn't pay close attention in science class when I was in school, but I know enough to know that vapor...
One thing is not the other.
...is not smoke. But here's a story from USA Today where teenagers have discovered a new way to inhale marijuana, e-cigarette vaporizers. According to a study released Monday, about 27% of high school students who have used both marijuana and e-cigarettes reported using the devices to vaporize cannabis. Those most likely to vaporize pot with e-cigarettes included males and younger students. E-cigarettes are designed to vaporize solutions containing nicotine, said co-author Megan Morian, but she noted teenagers are resourceful, and it was only a matter of time. Now, just to be clear on something here, I don't know exactly how this study was done, but the device that is used, that you would use to vaporize this solution of this nicotine propylene glycol based whatever solution that they have, is generally not the same device that you would use to turn plant material into a vapor. The plant material, THC,
that wouldn't be the same thing,
right? The plant material, the THC in there, is going to boil at a different temperature than will the nicotine glycol solution, and so it wouldn't necessarily be the same thing. I remember we used to have a product, Mark, in our studio. It was an advertiser with us that had those. It looked like a cigarette, but it had a little tip on the end of it that had the solution in it. And you wouldn't have been able to, you know, hollow that out and put in the marijuana. In fact, there's even, I've seen the vaporizers online that they've sold. And you can get, like, the base, the battery portion of the vaporizer. I have a vaporizer right here in the studio, as a matter of fact. You get the battery portion of the vaporizer, and then you can attach different things to the top portion of the battery. So you can get, like, the battery works with both marijuana and
it's a battery.
Right. And
it's not a vaporizer.
The solution. But the attachment has to be different. So I'm not saying that they've got it wrong necessarily, but
it's
the mainstream media, so it's not really a clear picture that they're
painting.
Pretty
much every story you read is going to have some kind of inaccuracy or something left out. This is just sort of the nature of of journalism.
Vaporizer, says the article, give kids a better way to hide what they're inhaling. Morian, an assistant professor at Oberlin College, says it's so much easier to conceal e-cigarette pot use. Everybody knows the characteristic smell of marijuana, but vapor is different. It's possible that teenagers are using pot in a much less detectable way. In fact, the first time I saw somebody using the vaporizer to use that on cannabis. In this case, it was cannabis oil, not the actual plant material. So there's different ways to do it with cannabis as well. But the way I saw that was I was at the – we were at Coins of the Kingdom, Mark, which was a Bitcoin conference down in Disney World.
Disney World, yeah.
And you and I were in the bar area of the hotel. It was one of the Disney World hotels. And there was – I'm not going to say who it was, but somebody had a vaporizer device, and they were utilizing it right there in the hotel lobby. And I sampled it as well at that time, and I
was sure one to do.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was really impressed. Like, you know, it was pretty cool that you could use cannabis openly, basically, and, you know, passing it around right there in the hotel lobby, and nobody batted an eye at it. Nobody had any idea.
Had that stinky smoke involved.
Exactly. And so it's, let's see here, researchers at Yale University based their findings on answers from a survey sent to nearly 4,000 Connecticut students. About 28% of the students in the study had tried e-cigarettes. Morian said the people should remember to be cautious when interpreting her findings. There have not been any other studies showing teens are using e-cigs to vaporize marijuana. She noted that scientists don't fully understand the health effects of e-cig vaporized cannabis. Well, you know, that may not be the case. I mean, there are certainly in Canada where there is medical marijuana, vaporization is very, very popular. In states where medical marijuana exists, vaporization is generally, is my understanding, the recommended way to do it. It's not as dangerous, clearly, as smoking the cannabis is. And so, because it doesn't have all the tars or whatever. You know, you don't have the smoke.
It gets it up to temperature enough to be inhaled, but not.
You're vaporizing the THC. You're doing the same thing with THC as you would do with nicotine. You're turning it into a vapor rather than setting it on fire and combusting those, that product. And so it's just a safer thing to do. And so one of the common objections to legalizing cannabis for medical purposes or not is that, well, smoking's still bad for the patient. You can't recommend a patient smoke. Well, okay, you don't have to. They can get a vaporizer. And that's generally, you know, besides consuming it, the safest thing to do. So I think eating cannabis probably safer than vaporizing it because it's not going through your lungs. But eating the cannabis will take longer for it to affect. So if you've got some sort of debilitating condition that needs to be affected right away, then the vaporizing would solve that and would not subject you to the dangers of smoking. 855-450-FREE is the number that you can join us here on Free Talk Live.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at patriotnecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
Patriotnecklace.com?
Patriotnecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from patriotnecklace.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be the Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC. .com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited here if you want to join us. 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. In some places, it's illegal to watch the shows that you are used to watching all the time on television.
Why is that?
The Walking Dead or whatever the heck it is that you like to watch. It's illegal to watch those shows in North Korea. We can discuss that if you'd like or whatever's on your mind. Let's go to Zach in Ithaca. Hey, Zach, are we back on the radio live in Ithaca this hour?
I have no idea. I just got off work, and then I go on Twitter, and then I saw you guys were talking about the settlement thing. So I used to listen to you guys when I drove a cab, but now I don't drive a cab anymore. I kind of more incidentally catch what you guys are talking about.
Gotcha. Because I was only just a curiosity because we had a couple calls from Ithaca recently, and we haven't had Ithaca callers recently because they moved us into the overnight hours there on most of the nights.
When it's not live? That defeats the whole purpose of the show.
Well, but, you know, it's radio, okay. And I'm not angry about it. The things change, and program directors have to do what they've got to do to make things fit and make things work. So I'd rather be on not live than not on at all. So
indeed.
I'm grateful that we're still there. Anyway, go ahead with what you were calling about.
Okay, so you guys they said that there's going to be a settlement because I can give you some quick background. I refamiliarized myself with the details, but this – this whole thing with the parody Twitter account in Peoria started. I originally read about this on Vice magazine because a guy who writes for them and who works in Peoria named Justin Glaw, he discovered this Twitter account because he thought it was funny and he was like actively promoting it amongst people he knew. And it turns out that the person responsible for it, he actually knew them in real life. And so they arrested the guy who was responsible for the Twitter account. And the first question was, how do you know Justin Glaw? And as things advanced, one of the major things is that they raided his house. It was found to be unjustified. He's getting a settlement because it was kind of a fascist thing to do. But his roommate got busted for pot possession. And this unconstitutional fascist search resulted in somebody getting caught for something they wouldn't have otherwise.
Oh, no.
And it's still like I'm on Story of the Summer Tumblr, it's Justin Claus thing, and he's talking about his friend guy whose name was Elliot shared with John Daniel, who's the creator. He ruled today the police were right in carrying out their search, will require, blah, blah, blah. So this is still affecting someone's life.
Wow. So they're saying that this guy can somehow be charged with marijuana possession because the police did an illegal search? I mean, that seems like fruit of the poison tree.
The judge ruled that the carrying out of the search warrant was legitimate. So anything that they found during that search is not necessarily thrown out of court, but they're going to have to justify why they were looking for drugs. And in those tweets, they were joking about the mayor doing drugs, one of which was weed and cocaine. So basically, they're not going to have to throw out his case necessarily, but it's for pot possession. I don't know how much
they're
pot
claiming. Hold on, just to be clear, they're claiming that in this situation with a guy running the fake mayor account in Peoria, Illinois, that they raided his house and that drugs were legitimately searched for because they mentioned on the Twitter account using drugs.
The mayor using drugs.
The fictitious version of the mayor on Twitter talked about using cocaine, marijuana, and snorting blow and smoking weed. So you can check it out on there.
I'm taking your word for it. I mean, it sounds believable because that's how ridiculous the government is. I mean, I totally buy that claim. I hope that whoever that roommate is has good legal assistance and is not going to take a plea deal on this.
Well, when it comes to legal assistance, that costs money.
That's
and
true.
It may be that the plea deal is better than the cost of the assistance.
Well, it doesn't
sadly.
Always. If the ACLU takes your case,
yeah, that'd be great.
That does not cost you anything.
Sadly, in this country, we have to kind of hope because it costs so much to get justice. It costs so much that you just kind of have to hope somebody will pay for it for you.
Zach, thanks for the update on that. Anything else you want to share tonight?
Yes. The main detail was I'm reading this write-up by Justin Glaw about what's going on. He and this other guy named Matt Bedell of the Journal Star there in Peoria have spent the last at least year detailing a lot of the corruption and essentially the kind of shadiness going on with the police department. So I think that is probably the original reason. It wasn't just the Twitter account itself was taken offense by the mayor. They're like, this is connected to Justin Glaw, who's criticizing us, who's looking into our business. They tried to apparently to set up one of the city council members in a prostitution sting. So it wasn't about the Twitter account, actually. It was about a way to go after these people and what they considered people opposing their power monopoly there in Peoria. That's my theory.
That's what it's about.
Thank you, Zach, for your call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Now, you know, if this guy does go to jail, so there's the two guys. There's the one guy and then his roommate. The one guy who was running the Twitter account, he's off the hook. They dropped those charges and they settled the case for over $100,000. I think it was $125,000 or something like that. So that one's settled. That one's, case closed. But this other guy, if he ends up going to jail for this marijuana possession, it's probably not going to be as bad as a prison camp in North Korea.
Probably not.
But the difference is really in degrees here, right? Like if you criticize Kim Jong-un or Kim Jong-il or what was the grandfather's name? Kim Sung? Kim Il-sung, right? Kim Il-sung. Am I right about that, Kim Il-sung?
Yeah, that sounds like the first guy.
The grandfather, right. So if you criticize them in North Korea, you might possibly end up in a prison camp. Maybe they'll kill you. I don't know what the punishment is for criticizing the dear leader, but it's probably pretty severe. And so Peoria, Illinois, just a difference in degrees, right? You criticizing the mayor in Peoria on the internet, joking about the mayor on a fake Twitter account labeled parody, led to a raid of someone's house while he wasn't there, led to two arrests, arresting the guy who ran the Twitter account and arresting the roommate for marijuana possession. And an arrest can ruin somebody's life.
It can.
If you've been arrested for something, a lot of times the company you're working for won't wait until you get convicted before they fire you. So a lot of people have had loss of a job, loss of a house because they've been arrested. They get arrested. They can't pay the rent because they've lost their job. You've just lost your home. Maybe you get arrested and you can't get out quickly because you don't have enough money to bail yourself out with because you've been working, paycheck to paycheck, and then you have to sit in jail and therefore you miss your next payment date on your rent, so therefore you don't even have the house when you get back out, even if you still have your job. So all these things can happen to people.
Sure.
And all of that happened in Peoria, Illinois, because somebody said something on the internet that the mayor didn't like. So the difference is only in degrees between the United States and North Korea. That's all it is.
I think a lot of people are looking at the situation. They say that, well, that's not happening in most places. If you created a...
What's not happening?
Well, if I created a satire mayoral account here in Keene, New Hampshire, and I went about tweeting dumb things about the mayor, chances
are good.
They'd
probably leave you alone.
I'm not going to get... and that's probably
true. This is New Hampshire, and it's not Illinois.
No, it's probably the majority of places. And Peoria is not in Chicagoland. Right,
it's still Illinois.
I understand.
This is one of the worst places in the United States.
It's a big government place, yeah. But Peoria is not known for its crime affiliations the same way Chicago is. I mean, when you're talking about corrupt places in the United States, you're looking at a list of places like Rhode Island, New Orleans. You know, you're looking at Chicago. Baltimore.
Plenty of smaller places have lots of corruption.
There are plenty of corrupt places like that too. I'm talking about the big cities, but Peoria isn't one of them, Ian. Peoria is just your average place where a mayor went out of control.
I don't know, man. I think that you would see this happening in other places as well. Anyway, toll free number for you to join us.
Go ahead and open up some mayoral account against somebody in some other place and see, and just start tweeting stuff.
I got enough going on.
Right. Well, then stop making just empty accusations like it's happening all over.
I didn't say it was happening all over. I said it could happen.
You said here in the United States. No, in Peoria.
Oh, please stop acting like Peoria is the only place where something like this would happen. There are places where people are being arrested for posting rap lyrics on Facebook. So there are a lot of things that your freedom of speech will end you up behind bars for here in the United States. And that's in both big cities and small. And in a smaller town like this, an account like that is more damaging, in theory, to the mayor's reputation. So they're more likely, probably, to attack you over it. Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. Blockitpocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at Blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. Blockitpocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Do you owe the IRS money? Do you have years of unfiled returns? Has the IRS garnished your wages or put a lien against your house? The IRS has the power to make you pay back what they claim you owe and will stop at nothing to collect. If you are losing sleep over your IRS tax problem, there is a solution. Call Signature Tax now. Speak with our professionals and feel the weight of your tax burden lifted from your shoulders. Call 800-643-4661 for your free and confidential analysis on ending your tax nightmare. We can help get your life back on track and give you the fresh start you deserve. Our A-plus BBB-rated tax resolution team has over 125 years of combined experience to get you the best deal possible while stopping the IRS dead in their tracks. Call Signature Tax now at 800-643-4661. Call 800-643-4661. Again, that's 800-643-4661. 800-643-4661.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. We got a few moments remaining. Enough time for you if you dial now. The toll free number is 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype. Skype on in here. Username's lrn.fm. And with you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Mark.
Don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com, and the features there are completely free. If you are enjoying the program, there are various different ways for you to support the show, and one of them is to come to Keenvention. Go to Keenvention. Actually, that doesn't really support the show, but it's a cool thing to do. Keenvention's coming up, and it's coming up fast. We're talking about less than 2 months now. It's Halloween weekend. That's right. October 30th through November 1st. Where else would you want to be for Halloween than
home of the most lit jack-o'-lanterns in the world?
That's true. Well, actually, I think Keene lost that.
No, I think it won it again.
It won it back?
Yep.
Because Boston had taken the trophy for a little
while. When
are
you living in? 2007?
I don't know. Boston had it for a few years.
Just go on, man.
Yeah. Anyway, so Keene, New Hampshire, great place to be for activism, for people who love freedom. You come to Keenvention, go to keenvention.info, and you can learn more about it. It's an activist-focused event where we talk about the activism that goes on here in New Hampshire. The difference between Keenvention and every other Liberty Convention is we don't pay fancy big-name speakers to come in from elsewhere and speak. Although...
except...
Although Gavin Andreessen... who is basically the head programmer for Bitcoin. This is the guy who Satoshi Nakamoto, the creator of Bitcoin, the anonymous creator of Bitcoin. Gavin was Satoshi's choice as the core developer, essentially, for Bitcoin. So Gavin was sort of anointed or benighted, if you will, by Satoshi to take over the reins of the project. And he's a very influential voice in the world of Bitcoin. He's going to be on the Bitcoin panel. This is huge news for Keenvention. And somebody said to me online after I announced it, well, you're going to need to update the about page on your website, because the about page explains that Keenvention focuses on New Hampshire activists, and that's who all of our
and he's a Massachusetts activist.
That's who all of our panelists and speakers are. They're people who are liberty activists in New Hampshire, either natives of New Hampshire or free staters, people who've moved here to achieve more liberty in our lifetime. But, you know, I can bend the rules if necessary, and in this case,
it's
I'm
your
doing
convention,
that. Right? I can do that, and I, you know, I don't feel like I need to update the page on the website that explains what Keenvention is about because we've changed one speaker who lives in Amherst, Massachusetts. He's closer to Keene than, you know, the people in the northern portion of New Hampshire,
even the seacoast.
Yeah. So the dude's local. He's not getting paid anything extra to come up here. There's a very small stipend that each of our speakers is able to receive.
Isn't that just a meal?
There's a choice. I give speakers a choice. They can choose.
All you ever offered me was a meal.
I'm sorry if I never offered you the gas stipend, Mark. If you'd really like the gas stipend instead of a VIP meal, you're welcome to have that.
I'd rather have the meal. It's really good.
Yeah, the people who come here and speak at Keenvention, this is an activist convention. It's not a big budget thing. So, you know, got to keep costs down. And so I want to give them a few bucks if that's what they would prefer, or they can have a VIP meal. So that's all Gavin Andreessen is getting. He's not getting anything different than any other speaker at Keenvention.
The home of the most lit jack-o'-lanterns on display is it's 30,581. It was achieved by the city of Keene, New Hampshire, represented by Let It Shine Inc. in Keene, New Hampshire, USA, on the 19th of October 2013.
Okay.
Keene was the original record holder in this category, and it has now been broken 8 times since the original attempt.
Yes, and so that's something that goes on, actually. That's like the week before Keenevention, so you won't be here on the same weekend, which is a good thing because you don't want to be here during Pumpkin Fest weekend, generally, because there's a lot of people in town, and the hotels cost a lot of money as a result. We actually hold Keenevention right on the outside of hotel season, so there's a certain leaf-peeping season that happens here, as they call it, in northern New England, where
the it's still beautiful, but... The peak leaf peeping season's over.
Correct. So the Keenevention is held just past the peak, and after peak is when the hotel rates drop dramatically. It goes from like $250 a night to $80 a night. And so I wanted Keenevention to be an affordable convention for anybody who can, if you can afford to make it to Keene, New Hampshire, the, whatever the travel costs are, then you can afford to attend this convention because it's only $60 or Bitcoin equivalent if you want to attend. You'll get to meet Gavin Andreessen. I haven't confirmed with him whether he's going to be staying for the entire weekend or not. I will check on that because the Bitcoin panel is going to be super, super important. This is a big time in the history of Bitcoin. And without getting too deep into it, there's a split in the behind the scenes of Bitcoin, a fork, a possible fork in the road, if you will. And, you know, I don't want to get too technical, but that can mean some very calamitous times possibly maybe coming for the Bitcoin network and the sort of the guts, the operational side of Bitcoin. And in order for that fork to happen, Gavin and his supporters have to convince 75% of the Bitcoin miners to switch to this new Bitcoin software that they've released that will essentially make the block size larger, and that will hopefully help Bitcoin scale up to a Visa and MasterCard kind of transaction levels.
That's the idea.
And so this is
at least we'll get to hear what he has to say about that, right?
Right, and his critics will get to question him, and I think it's going to be a very exciting.
Critics come.
Yeah, I think this is going to be a very exciting panel and a very, very important panel as well, especially at the time that it's happening. So go to keenevention.info and lock your tickets in. There's only 100 of them available in advance. This is an intimate convention. And again, that's keenevention.info. So, rare video footage, this from The Telegraph in the UK, has been filmed secretly and smuggled out of North Korea, showing an open-air public trial, outdoor trial, for two men who are being sent to a labor camp for crimes related to the so-called corrupt ideology of capitalism. The two accused, ages 30 and 27, are made to stand outside in front of a 100-strong crowd as the charges against them are blasted out of loudspeakers attached to a van. The men are condemned for carrying out a, quote, grave criminal act, unquote, which includes watching an American film that remains unnamed, putting it on a USB stick, and copying it onto a DVD recording device. The North Korean judge or official says that one of the defendants is, quote, a person immersed in the corrupt ideology of capitalism, unquote, and tells the crowd that the criminal acts were, quote, revealed by agents in South Korea operated by our party, unquote. During the full 12, so they've got spies who are supposedly,
it's the claim.
Yeah, who are supposedly, snitching on people who are watching television.
What if they just found the guys with the sticks and then just said, we have spies?
They could have done that too. During the full 12 minutes of footage filmed secretly by an onlooker and seen exclusively by The Telegraph, neither man is given the chance to speak, and both are sentenced to time in an unnamed correctional labor camp.
How long?
The exact length of the sentence appears to be around 9 months, although experts say around 1 to 2 years is common. The footage has emerged after a period of heightened tension in the region after North Korea threatened military action against South Korea until it put an end to the broadcast of messages aimed across the border via loudspeakers. A truce was eventually reached on the 24th of August. Hundreds of thousands of North Koreans are detained in prison camps for political crimes, according to Amnesty International, where executions, rape, and forced abortions are common. But common offenders are instead sentenced to time in labor camps for what the regime calls re-education, where the daily routine can include long days of manual work, heavily rationed food, forced ideology lessons, and little sleep. According to a translation of the judge's words, both men are said to work at Chungjin's thermoelectric power plant in Hamgyong Province, northeast of the country. The trial is under the jurisdiction of the People's Court judge of the Ranam district of Chongjin. The video footage filmed in September of 2013 confirms that accessing and watching American films is considered a serious crime against the North Korean state, despite the fact that the practice is widespread.
Yeah. Even Kim Jong. It's my understanding, like, just about everybody does this, and probably the people in the higher up portions of the government.
You're damn right Kim Jong-un is watching these movies.
Absolutely.
That's how he knows who Dennis Rodman is and, you know, all these other
They are superstars. Big basketball fans.
So even Kim Jong-un's father, Kim Jong-il, was a reported cinephile whose favorite actress was Elizabeth Taylor.
That's true. He was a big fan of you know, cinema. Yep.
So it's okay for the ruling party to watch.
It's the way it always is. Yeah. It's always okay for them. It's okay for them here, too. The idea that we have rule of law is ridiculous in this country. It's nonsense. You think the politicians have to follow the same rules you do? You know better. Don't believe that crap for a second. Do you think cops give each other tickets? You know they don't.
And this isn't going to stop the North Korean people from watching these movies, right? Like, they've arrested people here and gone after them for file sharing in the United States. So, you know, not that big of a difference here. But those folks that have been and gotten in trouble for sharing files online, that hasn't dissuaded the use of file sharing. There's millions of people right now probably downloading various different torrents full of movies and music and such. So again, the difference is only in the degrees of the punishment. By the way, since coming to power, Kim Jong-un has reportedly set up 114 surveillance teams specifically targeting a crackdown on foreign media. So this is a real big deal there.
114 surveillance teams. They're not broadcasting, are they?
Well, the only thing broadcasting in North Korea is the state.
State radio, yeah.
Yeah. So we're out of time tonight, but we'll see you tomorrow online. In the meantime, I'll put the full story up on our Facebook and Twitter. You can go to news.freetalklive.com to link over to those.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Be sure to visit GCNlive.com today.